Let's go. Okay, so guys, how are you doing? Today we have a webinar. This is going to be a crazy webinar. This is going to be a reality check. This is going to be something which you guys might not be aware of. We are going to talk about a lot of stuff that you might not be aware of right now. But as we go through the entire webinar, you will get a better idea. You will get a better understanding of everything that we have been trying to talk. And hopefully a lot of answers that you guys have been looking for, you are going to get in this webinar. This webinar is about personal transformation. This webinar is about the entire journey of a transformation. This webinar is about starting from a place or starting from zero and then reaching to a point where you are satisfied, where you are happy, and where you have everything that you want in your life. In terms of dating, in terms of social skills, in terms of attraction, in terms of people, in terms of lifestyle or social life. So a lot of the things that I'm going to be talking about in today's webinar, they might come off as a little bit of a shock. You might think that, bhai, ye concept kahan se aaya? You might be confused about some concepts or probably a lot of concepts that we are going to be talking about in the webinar. Again, this webinar is not a quick tip. This webinar is not like a hack. In this webinar, I'm not trying to give you a hack or a quick tip or, you know, some tricks and techniques. This webinar is only going to be understandable, and this webinar is only going to make sense to those people who have already worked on themselves, who have some idea of what they're doing in life, who have some idea of who they are. Okay. So if you're thinking that in this webinar, I'm going to give you the tricks of how to open, how to approach, that is not going to happen. This webinar is going to be about the entire build-up process. This webinar is going to be about the entire journey a guy takes from going from a place of being introverted, being shy, being low confident and everything to a place of becoming an alpha. So how to become that alpha, how to become that natural, how to become that integrated male. Okay, so this is what we are going to be talking about in the webinar. So everybody is excited, everybody is ready. So one more thing I would like to announce before we jump into the webinar is, wherever you are, quickly grab a pen and a paper so that you can be making notes, because you will get a lot of insights, you will get a lot of epiphanies as you are going through the entire webinar. So grab a piece of paper so that you can take notes, so that you can write your questions, because I am not going to be stopping in between and answering any questions. Let me repeat that once again. I'm not going to be stopping in between and answering questions. I will be taking all the questions and all the doubts at the end of the webinar. So probably after 1.5 hours or 2 hours, I'll be taking questions. So better, it would be amazing. It would be better if you write down every question or every doubt that you have, so that we can discuss this later. And if you get any personal insights as we are going through this webinar, that will also help. So we have 25 people. Time to start. Okay. So first of all, my journey, what I wanted, and maybe this is you. Maybe this is your journey too. Maybe this is something that you would like to have in your life too. Or maybe this is something that you actually want in your life. This is what I wanted when I moved from a small city, when I moved from a small town and I moved to Delhi. This is exactly what I wanted. I wanted to become a guy who is naturally charismatic, who does not have to go through so much effort, anxiety and negative emotions when we are talking to men and women. So I wanted to be a guy for whom everything was easy, for whom everything came naturally. I did not want to put out so much work, so much time, so much effort, so much energy in meeting people, in trying to impress other people or in trying to attract other people. I wanted to become like a magnet. I wanted to become like a magnetic personality so that everybody is chasing me, so that I am the high value person in everybody else's life. So I wanted to become a guy who is living life on his terms, who is not conflicted, who is not torn apart between my desires and my insecurities. And this is something that I think all of you are struggling with. Firstly, we want to approach people. We want to meet people. We want to build a good dating life. We want to build a good love life. We want to build a good sex life. We want to build a good social life. But we are insecure. There is something which stops us. So on one hand, we have our ambition. On one hand, we have our ambition, aspiration, and goals. But on the other hand, there are a lot of things that are stopping us. There are a lot of things. Maybe it can be low self-esteem. Maybe it can be you have no idea what to do. Maybe it can be any other thing. So we are conflicted between our desires and between something that is stopping us. That can be your insecurities. That can be your imperfections. That can be your flaws. That can be your weaknesses. That can be your ignorance. That you don't know something. Bahut sari cheeze hame pata nahi hai. So we might not be aware of those things that we need to learn. But this is what I wanted. I wanted to be unconflicted. I wanted to be on my path, on my purpose, and I wanted to develop a clear sense of being. I wanted to develop a strong sense of identity, a strong personality. Okay. I wanted to be charismatic and the center of attention. I wanted people to call me and ask me to hang out with them. I wanted to hot girls to be chasing me. I did not want to keep chasing everybody, right? I wanted to reach at a place where people are chasing me. People are trying to ask me out. People are calling me up and being like, hey bro, what's up? Why you're not here at the party? We are missing you. I wanted girls to call me and ask me like, hey Rahul, what's up? You have not been, you know, answering my phone calls. You have not been, you know, answering my texts. What is wrong with you? Why you're not talking to me? Why you're not giving me attention? I wanted this to be my life. I wanted to become a 10 for other people. I wanted to become that high value, that attractive person that everybody else wants to hang out with. Everybody else wants to spend some time with me, to get a piece of my time for them. I wanted to be a person of high value for whom other people are fighting or putting efforts and to spend some time with me. So can you guys relate to this? Do you guys also have the same things? Do you guys also go through the same emotions? Do you guys also have the same kind of goals, similar aspirations? I like to chase my girlfriend, not every girl on the street. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Lastly, I wanted to have a strong magnetic personality and a strong identity. I wanted to be somebody who people will talk to for even 5 minutes or even 10 minutes. And people will go home and be like, dude, you know what? I met this guy, Rahul. He's amazing. I got his phone number. And next time, whenever we are having a party, we are going to invite this guy. This guy is so fun. This guy is so amazing to hang out with. This guy has such a nice energy. I wanted to become that guy. I wanted to become that magnet, right? Like, thandi ke mausam mein aisa hota hai na, like have you seen like how moths or insects are attracted towards light, are attracted towards street lights, or maybe attracted towards tube lights or any kind of source of light, right? So I wanted to become that source of light so that other people can be attracted towards me, just like moths are attracted towards fire, or moths are attracted towards light. Insects are attracted towards light. I wanted to be the center. Okay. I wanted to be the center of everything that's been happening. So what do men and women actually want? This was the question that I asked myself. If I want to be the center of attention, if I want to be the magnetic personality, I have to give people what they really want. I have to give people what they're really looking for. I have to give people the kind of value that they want in their life. So at first, just like all of you, just like everybody else in the earth, on earth, I was like, yeah, looks, money, and status is going to work for me. So I started wearing better clothes. I started, you know, going to the gym. I started working on personal grooming, personal hygiene. I started working on my style and my fashion a little bit. I started doing the job in which I can get the most amount of money and I can feel a little bit high status. I can feel a little bit successful. But the problem I realized with looks, money, and status is that you can't give it to them. It doesn't matter how good looking you are. You can't give your good looks to me. Okay. You can't give your good looks to me. You can't give your cute face or your handsome face to a girl. You can't give your money to somebody else. right? You're not going to give half of your salary to somebody else. You're not going to give half of your success to somebody else. You cannot share these things, right? These things are for yourself. These things are there to make your life better. You should work on your health and your looks because you want to feel energetic, because you want to feel amazing in your own body, because you want to have the kind of energy that people are attracted towards, or not even people, just for yourself. These goals are selfish goals. People chase these goals for themselves, not for other people. So if you are chasing money or status or looks to impress other people, then you're going to fail because you cannot share these things with anybody else. You cannot share these things with other people. I want to love many girls and build great socials. Yeah, Vilash, you got it. So we can't share looks, money, and status with other people. But as we have talked about, if we want to be truly magnetic, we have to give other people what they want, right? We have to make other people feel what they want. We have to become a source. We have to offer value. But we cannot offer value in terms of looks, money, or status. There are not the things that we chase to impress women. We chase these things to make our life better. So what do other people actually want? What do women actually want? What do other men actually want? What are they going to follow? What are they going to be attracted towards? This was the question that I wanted an answer to. So other people want to be themselves. They want to feel accepted and they want to feel a sense of belonging. They want to feel like they belong to something. Okay. So other people want to feel belonged. Other people want to feel accepted. Other people want to be themselves. This is the reason other people go, or women and men in general, go towards people who are non-judgmental, who are being themselves. Because if I am being myself, then you also feel that, okay, this guy is being himself. I can also be myself around this guy. He is not going to judge me. He's going to accept me the way I am. Okay? He can accept me the way I am. So I can feel better about myself. So everybody in the world, all people, all men and women, they want to be themselves. They want to feel accepted. And they want to feel a sense that they belong somewhere, that they are a part of a group, that there are other people standing for them. Other people also want to follow somebody with a strong sense of leadership. So look at any great leader. Look at any charismatic person in the world. Any charismatic person in the world, okay? You will see that other people are very, very happy following them. Other people want a leader so that they can follow them and they can just subscribe to whatever they think. They can just accept whatever goals or whatever rules they have given them and they can easily follow. This is the case with a lot of kings, a lot of emperors, a lot of highly successful people, right? Why do so many people follow actors or celebrities? Why do so many people follow, you know, motivational speakers? Why do so many people follow sports people, right? People who are very, very good in sports, like Michael Jordan or Ronaldo. If you play football, then Ronaldo or Messi or Neymar. If you play cricket, then it might be Sachin Tendulkar. Or it might be, you know, it might be Dhoni. It might be, what was his name? This guy who is like a good cricketer, who is very famous right now. Virat Kohli. Yeah. So everybody wants to follow somebody. And when we say that we want to follow someone, what we mean is that we want to become like them. We want to become like that person. We want to follow somebody. We want to have an ideal to follow so that one day we have hope that we will become like them. We will become a person like them. So all people in the world, be it men or women, all people in the world want to follow something, want to follow somebody. That someone is generally a leader. And that person has a very, very strong sense of leadership, very, very strong sense of personal responsibility and responsibility for his community, responsibility for other people. Every leader has this. A leader is an alpha. When we're talking about one of the basic qualities of an alpha male is that he is a leader. Okay. He is a leader. He's a king. He's a warrior. He's somebody who plays the part of, you know, the God's messenger or an ideal to other people to look up to. Like, look at Amitabh Bachchan. For a lot of people, Amitabh Bachchan is like a miniature version of God. Look at other famous people who have, you know, who have been born, who have been a part of the world. Look at other famous people. Look at, for example, look at Abraham Lincoln. For a lot of people, Abraham Lincoln was like a god. For a lot of people, like look at Tony Robbins, right? Tony Robbins is one of the most successful self-help speakers in the entire world. Look at Tony Robbins. For a lot of people, Tony Robbins is like a mini god. He is like a mini king. He is like a guy who other people can trust and rely on, that he is going to take us to salvation. He is going to take us to where we want to go. We have our trust in Tony Robbins. We have our trust in certain leaders. For example, it can be Gandhi, it can be Martin Luther King, it can be Bhagat Singh, it can be Modi, it can be Trump, it can be Obama, it can be anybody, it can be Amitabh Bachchan, it can be Leonardo DiCaprio, it can be RSD Tyler, it can be Kshitij, it can be anybody else. So you want to subscribe to somebody else's worldview. You want to accept somebody else's worldview who is doing decent in life, so that you don't have to do the work yourself, so that we don't have to think ourselves. So an alpha is a person who is an ideal for other people to look up to. He is respected. The guy who is the alpha, other people follow him. Other people put their trust in him. Have you guys ever heard this saying that in Tyler we trust? This is a Fight Club saying. Have you guys watched Fight Club, first of all?
Yes.
Yes. So in Fight Club, you see how everybody blindly follows Tyler Durden. So what is Tyler Durden preaching? What is Tyler Durden saying that other people are attracted towards? What Tyler Durden is saying is that you have to become your own version. You have to become an individual. We have to become somebody amazing, right? But at the end, instead of becoming an individual, instead of developing their own personality, what they end up doing is they end up becoming a blind follower of Tyler Durden. So if Tyler says, go and kill this person, they will go and kill that person. If Tyler says, go and steal this bank, they are going to go and steal this bank. If Tyler says that, go and plant bombs in all the areas, they are going to plant the bombs in all the areas. Tyler says, question society. Tyler says that, bro, think for yourself. But at the end, what happens? What happens is that everybody else becomes a blind follower. Everybody else becomes a slave to the ideas, to the charisma of Tyler. We are going to talk a little bit more about this, but right now I just wanted to give you a general idea. Right now I just wanted to give you something to think. So most alpha people in the world, all the kings, all the queens, all the leaders, all the warriors, everybody who has been famous, who has been successful in the world, who you look up to, right? Everybody, they have two qualities to offer. They can only offer two things. And these two things are the most important things when it comes to human beings. Human beings cannot live without these two things. These two things are the most important thing. If you have no idea about anything in the world, and if you can just do these two things, people are going to follow you. People are going to love you. People are going to die for you. People are going to go crazy about you. Log tumhare pair ke niche jhuk ke tumhe salam karenge. If you can take care of these two things, what are these two things? First thing is every leader offers good emotions, positive emotions, positive energy. They offer things like hope. They offer things like dreams, salvation, victory, positivity, inspiration, motivation. This is what every leader gives you. So tell me some leaders that right now you're following. You can write it in the chat. You can write, you know, like your favorite leader in the chat. Go ahead. We are going to pause here and we are going to Look, for example, right now, a couple of people I used to follow in my life were RSD Tyler. I used to follow Tony Robbins. I used to follow some other speakers. I used to follow some authors. So, Raj says that he follows Grant Cardone. So, Raj, come on the speaker for a while. Stefan says that he follows Jordan Peterson. So, Raj, come on the speaker for a while. Is it true or is it false that Grant Cardone gives you some hope, a dream, a salvation, a victory, positivity, or inspiration? Is it true or not?
Rahul, can you please pardon?
Is it true that Grant Cardone gives you things like hope, dreams, salvation, victory, positivity, emotions, and good emotions?
Yeah, true.
Right? So the same thing, Ronaldo. Why do we follow Ronaldo? Because Ronaldo acts as a personal hero. We might not be consciously aware about it, but Ronaldo becomes a personal god, right? A personal mini god, a miniature god. Ronaldo becomes a religion, just like Jordan Peterson. Why do so many people follow Jordan Peterson? Because Jordan Peterson stands for the truth. Jordan Peterson stands for the truth. Jordan Peterson is somebody like, bro, I'm going to stand my own ground and I'm not going to be bullied by the society. Society gayi bhaand mein. Jo mera man hai, main wo karunga. Jo mujhe lagta hai sach, main wo bolunga. And a lot of people resonate with this idea. A lot of people put their trust, put their life, put their entire identity behind Jordan Peterson because they want to follow this guy. They want to follow Jordan Peterson wherever he goes. They want to follow Jordan Peterson. This is so important that when a lot of alpha people or when a lot of leaders or kings die, a lot of people feel like killing themselves too. This need is so deep in our brain that when we hear that our personal hero has passed away or something bad has happened to our personal hero, we also feel that we have lost a part of ourselves. Has this ever happened with you guys? Have you ever felt this? Kiran says Jason Statham. Wow, man. Jason Statham is an actor. I don't know much about Jason Statham, but I think he's a cool guy. Girish Pradhan, Prabha. Girish Pradhan is the singer of Girish and the Chronicles, right, Pradhan? Right, Prabha?
Yeah.
I have seen that guy. I have met that guy.
Jason is an action hero of Hollywood movies.
Huh, I know Jason Statham is an action hero, but I don't know him personally. I've just watched his movie. I love his movies, but I don't follow him. Robert Downey Jr. and Johnny Depp, Abhilash, Robert Downey Jr. So, guys, can you tell me something that you have learned from Jason Statham? Like Kiran, can you tell me something that you have learned from Jason Statham?
Well, I admire his patience and control over things, even in the situations that swipe him off his feet.
How much aware you are of his personal life, of what kind of person he is, of you know what his values are or what his belief systems are? How kitna?
In his personal life, I don't know anything about his character.
Yes.
But he is a person who is dedicated mm-hmm. and committed to whatever he is doing.
Mm-hmm.
He knows martial arts.
Mm-hmm.
He has been. He does a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
I know that, and he is. Actually, in the movies, he's an action hero, but even in the way he speaks and speaks in the places apart from the movies or even in a public gathering, he actually represents that face. Like he is actually aware of a situation. He has the situation in control, even if it is something that is really terrible.
Got it. So people who, posted names of celebrities like Jason Statham, Girish Pradhan, Robert Downey Jr., Johnny Depp, Vladimir Putin. Wow. So people who have, many people felt that way with Netaji Bose. Yes, Subhash Chandra Bose, right? People were ready to die for him. People were like, bro, agar Subhash Chandra Bose gaye jail mein, so main bhi jaunga jail mein unke saath. I don't give a fuck about my life. I am ready to sacrifice my life for this person. So this is how crazy it is if you actually understand it. So yeah, coming back to the point, a lot of people who follow celebrities like Shah Rukh Khan, like Johnny Depp, Brad Pitt, or, you know, like Robert Downey Jr., Jason Statham, these people. So what happens is we get seduced by their screen persona. We get seduced by their screen personality. In real life, they might be completely different. In real life, they might be completely different, just like any YouTuber. Look at Beer Biceps. On his YouTube channel, he seems to be like a perfect person, right? He has everything under control. He is fit. He has money. He is successful. He's famous. So we think that this guy is perfect because we like him. We think that this guy has life in control. He has understood life because he's portraying, he's marketing himself like that. And this is the reason a lot of other people follow him. This is the reason a lot of other human beings follow him, because human beings don't want to follow other people who are going through their own struggles. Because we want to follow somebody who is perfect. We want to follow the people who have no flaws. We want to follow the people who have understood life, who have control on life. We want to follow these people who are perfection. And what does it remind us of? It reminds us of the image of a godlike, right? A godlike image. It reminds us of the image of perfection, like a, you know, king-like figure or like an angel-like figure. That when you see this person, all of a sudden, your negative energy goes away. All of a sudden, the self-doubt goes away. When you hear Grant Cardone talking, or when you hear, you know, all these celebrities talking. Oh, Meshach said Nisha. Nice. So when we hear these celebrities talking, all of our worries go away. We feel empowered. Have you guys ever had a friend or a person in your own life that was very, very alpha, that was very charismatic, that was very, you know, assertive, that had a very dominant personality? Have you ever had an opportunity to be with somebody like that? Yeah. So Himanshu, try to notice, try to observe this. When you are around a person like that, don't you feel a little bit more self-confident? Don't you feel that if I have a little bit of what this guy has, I can be so much successful? We like to be around these people. Yes, we like to be around these people, because when we are in front of that personality, when we are in front of somebody who is an alpha, somebody who is a leader, somebody who is a strong leader, right? If we are in the presence of somebody who is like Tyler Durden, or somebody who is like a king, we feel that we can transfer ourselves to them. We can rely on them. We can give ourselves to them. It becomes addictive to us. We want to be his friend. We want to be near that person. We want to be friends with that person, so that it can give us a sense of certainty. We can value also security. Yeah, we can also value security. So this is the reason, like, for example, if you take a boot camp with me or anybody else in the world, as long as the boot camp is going, you will feel like a superhero. Has anybody else taken a boot camp in their entire lives with anybody else?
Not yet.
So if somebody has taken a boot camp, just write in the chat, yes. Any kind of boot camp, or any kind of personal coaching, any kind of guidance, any kind of mentorship. Okay, so I think that a lot of people have not taken a bootcamp. So you will notice that when you come out on a bootcamp with me, one-on-one bootcamp with me, you will feel that you are a superhero. You will feel like you have some superpower. You will feel that you can approach any girl. GMC is an online. I'm talking about in person. I'm talking about a situation in which you are with the coach live in person. So this is a very common problem with people. They say that, bro, when I was with that coach, everything made sense to me. I was like, yes, I can do this, I can do that. I felt a little bit more confident. But as soon as I go away, like, for example, I was teaching, Abhishek, Tushar. I have been, in the last few months, I have had some students that I give boot camps to. And when they were with me, they were getting results. They were actually approaching. They were actually getting results. They were actually getting dates. They were actually getting numbers. They were also getting makeouts in the daytime. But as soon as I left, as soon as the bootcamp ended, they returned back to the same old position. They returned back to the same old story. I'm going to tell you a story about a guy whose name is Harsh Bharwani. So Harsh Bharwani is a guy who was the first PUA in India, who was the first pickup coach of India, right? He went to US and he took boot camp with Tyler and with Julian. He became so good at game that he started coaching with RSG. He started going to the same events with RSG as a coach. He became so good at game, right? And in India, he came and gave a boot camp. So all his boot camps used to happen in Thailand. It was a 30-day event. So people have to go to Thailand for 30 days. The fees was something like 3 lakhs, 2.5 lakhs or 3 lakhs or something for 30 days of coaching, right? So there were 15, 20 people who would go to Thailand with Harsh Bharwani to take the boot camp, to take the coaching. And this is, I was talking to a friend of mine who has attended his boot camp, who has attended his mentorship, one-on-one coaching. He told me that, bro, when we went to the club, there were so many hot girls. There were so many amazing, good-looking people. There were so many highly successful people and rich people in the club that we became stuffed in our head. We became stuck. We became stifled. We were like, bro, what the fuck? How is this going to work? How are we going to approach these hot girls? Because in Thailand, you have a mixture of girls, right? You have a mixture of people from this country, that country, from all over the world. We have a mixture of different kind of people from all over the world. So what happened? These people were very in their head when the bootcamp actually started. But when Harsh Bharwani showed up, after 3 hours, most people were making out with a girl. That person, this is what that person had said to me, word by word. I'm repeating word by word. He said that, bro, at first, I felt that I won't be able to do anything. I felt that I was, nobody here. Nobody would even look at me because I am not good looking. I am not rich. I have just passed the college, right? I don't have a job yet. And people here are coming in BMW, in Jaguar, in Audi, in Mercedes. Some people are coming in a fucking Hummer. Some people are coming in a limousine. So these people were super rich, super amazing people. But after Harsh came, his energy, and guys, main word by word quote kar raha, right? So that guy said that his energy was so infectious that everybody in the period of 3 hours, everybody became confident. Everybody started approaching. Everybody started getting numbers. Everybody started getting makeouts. Some people, also pulled. His energy was so good. So this is the power. This is the power of being an alpha. This is the power that you get when you actually become somebody that we want to become. And this is what people want. People want that power. People want to be around people with power, people with some kind of control on the world, people who have an idea of what's fucking happening in the world. People don't want to be around people who are clueless. Like, bhai, isko to kuch pata hi nahi hai duniya mein kya ho raha hai, anchut kuch bhi karte rehta hai, din bhar sota hai, din bhar movie dekhta hai, din bhar, daru peeta hai. So people don't want to be around other people like that. People want to be around other people that have some kind of control, that have some sense of power in their own life. And the other thing that a leader offers, or that an alpha male offers to other people, is a sense of certainty. Is a sense of certainty. Like, bhai, kuch bhi ho, we are going to reach there. Bhai, kuch bhi ho, trust me, aaj hum jeet ke jayenge. This is the reason we liked Dhoni, right? We like the Indian people love Dhoni so much. Why? Because he was a good leader. He knew how to control the team. He is like, bhai, kitna bhi bura match ho, we are going to fucking win this match. This is the reason people like Michael Jordan. बिकॉज चाहे कितनी ही बुरी कंडीशन में है उसकी टीम, व्हेन माइकल जॉर्डन शोड अप दे न्यू दैट दे आर गोइंग टू विन. दे गॉट दैट सेंस ऑफ सर्टेनिटी, दे गॉट दैट सेंस ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस, लाइक नाउ माइकल जॉर्डन इज ऑन आवर साइड, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फकिंग विन एंड नोबडी कैन स्टॉप अस. Yes, bro. It is going to be posted on YouTube. Don't worry, guys. The entire thing is going to be posted on YouTube. I'm recording this. So people want two things that an alpha male can offer, or that a king can offer. The first one is positive emotions, positivity, hope, dreams, salvation, victory, inspiration, motivation. A feeling of being accepted, a feeling of belonging, like we belong to something bigger than ourselves. This is what alpha males have to offer. The second thing that alpha males have to offer is certainty. Alpha males are very certain about this. Alpha males are like, bro, there is a battle. When I show up to the fucking battle, we are going to fucking win. Have you guys seen this movie, Troy? Troy is a movie by Brad Pitt. Have you guys seen that movie?
Yeah. It's a war movie.
It's a war movie. Have you guys seen Gladiator?
Yeah.
You guys have seen Gladiator, right? So you saw how when Gladiator comes to the war, to the battlefield, everybody else got hyped up. At first, everybody was thinking that, bro, we are not going to win this war. What is wrong with us? Why are we fighting? But when Gladiator comes, everybody is ready to fucking die. Because Gladiator is on our side. The same thing happens in the movie Troy. When Troy came to the battle, people felt a sense of confidence. People felt that they have a superpower. People felt that nothing can stop them. This is the power alpha males have. And this is the power I wanted to have. Because I wanted to become an alpha. I wanted to become a king in my own life. I wanted to become a mini god. I wanted to become somebody that people are going to love, people are going to follow, people are going to fucking die for, people are going to suck my dick, people are going to call me for parties, people are going to call me for everything and anything. I wanted to be the center of attraction. I wanted to be the magnet that is attracting everybody else. I wanted to be a person that agar main bas ek party mein gaya, even if I'm not doing a lot of pickup, even if I'm not doing game, everybody else is like, bro, give me your number, I want to meet you, tell me when are you free. Girls are coming up to me and girls are telling me like, hey, what's up? Are you dating somebody? Do you have a girlfriend? Would you like to go out? This is what I wanted for myself. I wanted to become an alpha. I wanted to become a king. I wanted to become a leader, right? So I had to learn two things. And these two things are the foundation of entire game, entire charisma, entire attractive personality. Everything revolves around these two things. First one is good emotions. Second one is certainty. If you can give good emotions to somebody, they are going to love you. If you can give certainty to somebody, they're also going to love you. If you give both of them, then they're going to fucking die for you. This is the reason people choose other coaches who are very self-assured, who are very confident of themselves, who are very certain of themselves. People like to choose those coaches. Even if the coach is charging 1 lakh rupees, people are happily going to give that 1 lakh rupees because that coach, that leader has said with ultimate confidence, like, bro, listen, if you come to my webinar or if you come to my coaching, you are going to achieve all your dreams. You are going to achieve all your goals. All your dreams are going to come here. So this is why people like to follow leaders. People like to follow big coaches. So far, everything is making sense to you guys. Are you guys following this? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, bro. There is a movie 300. In that also, it's crazy. When Leonidas comes, everybody's like, fuck yeah, we are going to win the fight. We are going to win the battle. Even if they are just 300 people fighting against 10,000 people, right? Soch ke dekho. 300 log aur 10,000 log. How can 300 people have the balls to fight against 10,000 people, knowing that they're going to die, right? That is the power of that. So far we have been talking about what men and women actually want. So far we have been talking about the architecture of an alpha male, what an alpha male is like, why do people love alpha male so much? Why do people love kings so much? Why do people love leaders so much? It's because of these two things. Kings give them these two things: emotions, good emotions, and a sense of certainty. That as long as I am here, किसने ये शाहरुख खान वाली movie देखी है? मैं हूँ ना. So उसमें वो बोलता है ना, मैं हूँ ना, tension मत ले. It became kind of famous. Similar to Battle of Saragiri. Yes, similar to Battle of Saragiri. If you guys have watched the movie Braveheart, have you guys watched the movie Braveheart? That is also a medieval war movie. उसमें भी
yeah.
Right?
Bomb diffuser की movie.
Yes, yes, exactly. Awesome. So you guys are enjoying the slide, huh?
I love it, man.
Loving it. So what it is to be like an alpha male? This is called the charisma of an unconflicted man. So there is a book by Ernest Baker. In that book, he talks about the charisma of an unconflicted individual. The charm or the attraction of a guy who is unconflicted, who is strong. Can I type the name of the movie and the book? The name of the book is The Denial of Death. It's a very kind of a mindfuck book, bro. So right now I would suggest you don't read it. Right now you, like, this is a book that you should later read in your life. Right now there is a lot of jargon in that book. So anyways, what it is to be like an alpha: the charisma or the charm of an unconflicted man. In order to be an alpha, an integrated man, an individuated man, you need to master your body and your mind first. You need to integrate yourself first. So every leader has mastered himself to some extent, more than other normal people, right? Every leader has mastered himself to some extent. Every pickup coach has mastered his communication, has mastered his game to some extent. This is why you follow them. Every, you know, business coach has mastered something. This is the reason you follow them. So in order to become that alpha, the first stage is we must individuate ourselves. We must integrate all aspects of ourselves and all our personality towards one direction. We need to become whole. We need to collect all the broken pieces and combine them and join them. And we need to become whole. We need to become an integrated male. Next point is how to be an alpha, or what it is like to be an alpha, how to get that charisma of an unconflicted man. Understanding that your ego / persona / identity / self-image, all of these things are the same thing. Your ego, persona, identity, self-image, all of these things are the same thing. And it's not negative, it's not positive. We don't have to place judgments on this. यहाँ पे हमें duality नहीं कर, यहाँ पे we don't want to have duality. We don't want to introduce duality of judgment, like good or bad. We don't want to, right now, everything that we're talking is beyond good and evil, is beyond good or bad. I'm so happy that I quoted Nisha. So right now, everything that we have been talking about is beyond morality, is beyond good or bad. हम लोग judgment के ऊपर उठ चुके हैं. So I told you guys, this is not going to be easy to understand, or this is not going to be a very, very simple webinar. This is not going to be a very basic webinar of, bhai, you know, indirect approach kar de, bhai, directional approach kar de, bhai, push-pull kar de. We are not talking about that, right? I want to challenge you to dive a little bit deeper. I wanted this webinar to be very, very challenging to you. I wanted this webinar to provoke some thoughts into your head. I wanted this webinar to take you deep into the rabbit hole and to show you the reality of what it actually takes to reach that. Because to be honest, a lot of other people are not going to talk to you about this. A lot of other people are going to give you tricks like, bhai, follow this 3-step formula, you are going to reach there. Follow this 7-step process, you are going to reach there. Follow this 5-step process to get any girl that you want. And human beings are inherently attracted toward those kind of things, right? Human beings are inherently attracted towards those kind of things. Think about what would sell more. If you sell something like get 6-pack abs in 6 days, how well it is going to sell? Everybody's going to buy it, right? Everybody's going to buy something in which they don't have to work, in which they don't have to use their own brain. This is the reason eating fresh, working out, meditating is so difficult for a lot of people. Because people want to be told what to do by a leader. People are like, bhai, mere ko follower banna hai. I want to become a slave. Just tell me what to do, I'll follow you. Just tell me what to fucking do, I'll follow you. People want to become a slave of a higher person, of an alpha male, of an integrated male. People want to become, I know some women, okay? I have some female friends. And their boyfriends were very, very abusive. And मैं सोचता था यार इसका बॉयफ्रेंड इसको थप्पड़ मारता है इसका बॉयफ्रेंड इसे मुक्का मार रहा है इसका बॉयफ्रेंड इसको फिजिकली अब्यूज कर रहा है Why the fuck is she still with that guy? Why the fuck is she still like, I love this person, I love this man, I love this man? क्यों? Why can't she leave him? Because they don't want to break away. They will become a slave rather than becoming an individual of their own. It is easy to fucking be a slave, okay? This is the reason that most of the YouTube videos or most of the books, the popular books that you will see, they're very easy. They are based on one aspect of life. For example, if you read something like, let's say if you're trying to read, there is a book, Iron John by Robert Bly, right? That book is one of the best books for men in the world. The title of the book is A Book About Men, Iron John. So you guys can search about Iron John and you guys can read it. That book is amazing. But that book is so hard to understand. That book is so fucking difficult to understand that it will never become famous. It will never become famous. So in order to understand this, in order to understand the entire thing that I'm telling, is that bhai, dawai kadvi hoti hai. Truth kadva lagta hai. Sach kadva lagta hai. If you want a good lie, if you want a beautiful lie to focus on, go and focus on some beautiful lies. This is not for you. If you want to be a part of the matrix and return to that life, return to the blue pill, then go ahead. No judgment. Bhai, I understand life is very difficult. I understand, Ibanchod, we are conscious beings. We know that someday we are going to die. And with that information, how the fuck are we still sane? I understand that. I have empathy for every human being, for everybody. Right? For everybody who wants to become a slave, who wants to follow a religion, who wants to follow any kind of religion, whether it is a supernatural religion, or whether it is the religion of a coach, or whether it is the religion of anything else, right? We want to be like, why do people go to magic shows? Because people want to be, delusioned. Logo ko achha lagta hai when somebody comes in front of them and, he offers a delusion, he offers a maya in front of them. People love it. People love being distracted from the reality. Why do people like smoking weed? Because bro, ganja fukne ke baad, you forget about the reality. Why do people like drugs? Why do people like sex? Because when you're having sex with somebody, you forget about the fucking reality. We want to escape the reality. Kyun jaye hum? Kyun itni mehnat kare hum? Sach janne mein? Kyun hum itni mehnat kare khud ko janne mein? Why the fuck do we have to work so much to improve ourselves, to become an alpha male, to become an integrated person? Right? Why? We can just follow 5 steps to success, right? We can just follow 5 steps to success. Ek coach ne bol diya, bhai, ye 5 steps follow karo. I am going to follow that. Bhai, mere ko nahi karna ye sari cheeze. I just want to follow. Mere ko itna dimag nahi lagana. Just give me something to fucking follow. Yeah, bro. Yeah. Most of the content is going to be in English. There are some things that are going to be in Hindi too. So again, we are talking about the second point here only. Your ego, your persona, your identity, your self-image is the seat of your consciousness. Everything that enters your awareness, right? every kind of sound, every kind of sight, every kind of smell, every kind of taste, every kind of experience that you go through is going to be directly calculated or directly interpreted by your ego. अगर मैंने एक बंदी को अप्रोच करा, उस बंदी ने मेरे को बोला, डूड प्लीज स्टॉप, आई डोंट वांट टू टॉक टू यू, इट इज गोइंग टू बी डायरेक्टली अफेक्टिंग माय ईगो, इट इज गोइंग टू बी डायरेक्टली अफेक्टिंग माय आइडेंटिटी, माय सेल्फ इमेज, बिकॉज एवरीबडी थिंक्स दैट दे आर अट्रैक्टिव, एवरीबडी थिंक्स दैट दे आर द बेस्ट, यू नो दैट दे हैव एवरीथिंग सॉर्टेड, बट व्हेन अ गर्ल रिजेक्ट्स यू, all of a sudden reality hits, all of a sudden you are like, oh fuck, I am not perfect, I am not amazing. Everybody wants to believe that they can go out and they can get a girl, but when you actually go out and do that, all of a sudden reality slaps you in the fucking face and the reality tells you, bhai tu abhi itna hai, itna hi reh, don't try to fucking fly. Okay, reality tells you, real world is very harsh, real world is very 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 harsh. It does not give a fuck about your emotions. I hate the COVID lockdown, but what can I do? Kuch nahi kar sakta main. I don't want to be in the room. I want to go out, you know, approach some girls. I want to make infield videos. I want to be giving boot camps. I'm feeling angry that those also we are stuck in this COVID. We are stuck in the lockdown. But reality does not give a fuck about my emotion. Reality does not give a fuck about your emotion. This is the reason a lot of people hate going outside. This is the reason a lot of people hate meditating. Because when you actually go out, you put yourself at the risk of being rejected. And when you are rejected, it hurts your fucking self-image. Huh? It hurts your fucking identity. You're like, bro, main to sochta tha main kitna acha insaan hu. Main kisi se hi baat kar sakta hu. Lekin main abhi tak 1000 बंदी को अप्रोच कर चुका हूं, एक बंदी ही मेरे साथ घर नहीं आई. ऑल ऑफ अ सडन रियलिटी हिट्स, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन यू अंडरस्टैंड कितने पानी में है तू, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन यू अंडरस्टैंड ऑन व्हाट लेवल यू स्टैंड, ऑन व्हाट लेवल यू आर स्टैंडिंग. सो ईगो इज द सीट ऑफ योर अवेयरनेस और द सीट ऑफ योर सेल्फ कॉन्शियसनेस. एवरीथिंग इन योर कॉन्शियसनेस इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय योर ईगो, एवरीथिंग. And you cannot get rid of this. You can never get rid of this. Even a person who is sitting in Himalayas and a person who is meditating since last 10 years, he also has an ego. But his ego is different than our ego. His ego is like, bro, I'm a yogi. I like sitting in Himalayas. If you ask him, bro, Why aren't you having sex? Why aren't you going out to clubs and having sex with other girls? He is going to say, is it because I am a yogi? It is not what I desire. I desire enlightenment. The moment I comes into a sentence, the moment I, me, myself comes into a sentence, you are speaking from your ego. So if you go to anybody, like if you go to Sadhguru right now, and if you ask him, Sadhguru, why don't you get a fucking tattoo? Tattoo kyun nahi karwata tu? Right? Why don't you shave your head? Why don't you go to parties? Why don't you do all this stuff? Why do you always keep talking about one thing and one thing only? Sadhguru is going to tell you, anybody, I'm telling everybody is going to say the same thing. Sadhguru is going to tell you, because I am a guru. I am a coach. I help people. I am enlightened, I am liberated. This I is his ego. He has an image of himself in his head that he is Sadhguru and he is supposed to be doing things like this. He is not going to go out and hit on chicks, right? He is not going to go out and do night game, because that is not what Sadhguru is. Sadhguru, but talk about anybody else, okay? Talk about anybody else. Everybody else has an ego. And they tell us that you need to kill your ego. Why do they tell us that you need to kill your ego? Why are other people preaching this, that you need to kill your ego? You need to kill your ego. You need to kill your ego. Kya hai itna bura ego mein? Why do I need to kill your ego? Any answers, guys? Any thoughts?
Yeah, bro. Like ego. Yeah, they say that to kill ego because ego is a very like can we say like a very hard like strict rule. Like, bhai, ye line hai. Iske siva kuch nahi hai. Iske alawa main hui nahi. Ye qualities hai. But in life, bro, like everything is like different. Like that, the thing that you said. So yeah, bro. That is why they want to kill this ego because it gives pain, bro. Yeah.
Good. What else? Do you think that Gautam Buddha did not have ego?
I think he had, but that ego, Gautam Buddha's ego, is like, शायद उसकी ego उसकी खुद की है. It's not related to the world or like outside or वो अलग है. ईगो इज सिर्फ उसकी जो मतलब ब्रो लाइक मैंने भी लाइक व्हेन लाइक मैंने भी थोड़ा अपना बाउंड्री सेट करी है कि लाइक मैंने भी अपना मतलब मेरा पर्सनल जो अपना इमेज बनाई है मैंने इस तरह लाइक सक्सेस की मैंने जो इमेज बनाई इट्स नॉट रिलेटेड टू आउटसाइड रियलिटी लाइक मेरा सक्सेस की इमेज जो बनी है लाइक दैट इज की भाई मैं अपना एक्शन ले रहा हूँ 100% और मैं कल से 1% ज्यादा इम्प्रूव कर रहा हूँ जो बाहर जो होता है वो होता है तो लाइक शायद दिस इज लाइक फॉर मी सक्सेस इज दिस तो मेरी ये ईगो है बट इट्स नॉट रिलेटेड टू बाहर के वर्ल्ड से तो मैं कॉन्फ्लिक्ट पे नहीं आऊंगा शायद ब्रो शायद
सो योर ईगो इज इट्स अ गुड थिंग दैट यू सेड दैट यू हैव क्रिएटेड ओवर योर ओन ईगो राइट यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट योर ईगो इज एंड व्हेन यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट योर ईगो इज यू कैन मोल्ड इट यू कैन डेवलप इट यू कैन हैव अ मैच्योर ईगो यू कैन मैच्योर योर ईगो राइट So the difference between a normal person's ego and somebody like Sadhguru or Gautam Buddha or any other, you know, superhuman person, their ego and our ego is different because their ego is integrated. They have control on their ego. They understand their ego. They can change it. But we, normal people, most of the generation cannot do that. Most of the generation is stuck. They can't do it. And Talking about one thing also, the point that I wanted to mention is everybody tells you to kill your ego because when you kill your ego, you kill your identity, you kill your individuality. You become a good follower. A person with no ego is a very good follower. A person with no ego can be easily made into a slave. Right? All you have to do is tell him something good, like, bro, follow this, you will reach God. Follow this, you will reach enlightenment. Follow this, you will reach self-actualization. And that person, since he does not have identity, since he does not have his own structure of the world, his own worldview, his own belief systems, his own value systems, since he does not have all these things, he can be easily manipulated. He can be easily manipulated. So this is a trick that has been happening over the world. Since last thousands of years, this has been happening. A person comes, a person says that, bro, God has sent me to tell you these things. That person tells a couple of things to other people and he becomes a God. He becomes a messenger of God or he becomes God himself. And other people follow him. Other people start following him because other people have very, very, very weak egos. Other people have very weak egos. And the self is the center of your entire being. Your conscious, your unconscious, your shadow, your anima animus, and your soul. So again, we are going into a little bit into deep psychology, which I just wanted to mention a little bit here so that you have an idea what we are talking about, what is the context of this entire webinar, and we can move ahead. So the point is, the moral of the story is the ego is important. So you must develop a healthy ego or a healthy persona. All charismatic people have a strong ego, which is mature and which is integrated. Every individual, right? Every individual. Gandhi himself said that I am a non-violent person. I don't like violence. The moment I came into the picture, it is a reflection of his ego. He is projecting his ego that violence is bad. Another part. You know, opposite of Gandhi, Hitler had an ego And it doesn't matter if it is a good ego or bad ego, right? It doesn't matter. Hitler had an ego that we must kill other people so that we can become better. We must kill other people so that we can become better. So Hitler had an ego just like Gandhi did, but Gandhi's ego was different. He identified with non-violence, but Hitler identified with violence. Hitler identified that we are Aryan race and we are superior to other human beings. So we must kill other human beings to prove our superiority. But Gandhi said, I don't like violence. Both are ego. One is a good form of ego. One is a bad form of ego, right? Osho also has an ego. Osho also has an ego. And other people, somebody else like a criminal also has an ego. Everybody has an ego. You cannot get rid of this. What we need to do is we must develop a healthy, a mature ego. We must develop an ego that is beneficial to us, that is strong, and that is amazing. All charismatic people have a strong ego, which is mature and which is integrated. Other people buy into you when you have an ego. They idealize you. They worship you when you have a good ego, when you have a mature ego. So you must have a strong sense of reality, a strong worldview, a strong belief system, a strong identity, and a strong sense of self-esteem. These are some things that, makes up ego. All these things together make up ego. Your worldview, your sense of reality, your sense of self, your self-image, your belief systems, your identity, your value systems, your self-esteem. These things make up your ego. These things don't go into your consciousness. These things don't go into your subconscious mind. These things are conscious. These things happen in ego. Moving ahead. So finally, we come to the point where we are having a reality check. Can you give an example of mature, healthy ego that leaders have? Okay, let's say, let's talk about RSD Tyler, right? Everybody knows RSD Tyler, who RSD Tyler is. Now we are going to talk about mature ego and immature ego. Let's talk about me. Let's forget about RSD Tyler. Let's talk about me. If I go out, and if I'm approaching, let's say I approach 10 people, and if I come home and I get 10 rejections, what am I going to think? I'm going to think that right now I'm a little bit rusty. I'm going to think that right now I need to go more and practice a little bit more. This is what I'm going to think, right? But a person with a weak ego is going to think something like this. If he goes out and if he get 10 rejections, he's going to think like, bro, I am a failure. I am flawed. I am bad. I am unloved. I am broken in some way. So if I get 10 rejections or if I go through a breakup, this is what I'm going to think. Right? And this is a part of my ego. This is a part of my healthy ego, my persona. I'm going to think that it's okay. Breakup ho gaya. I went through a breakup. I know it's sad. I know I wanted to be with that person, but what can I do now that we have broken up? So this is a chance that I can grow even more. This is a chance that I can get even a better partner for myself, even a better person for myself, even a better girlfriend, even a hotter girlfriend for myself. This is my ego. But if I have a weak ego, if my girlfriend left me, I'm going to get into depression. I'm going to think like, "Bhai, my life doesn't make any sense. I don't have a reason to live anymore. I might become suicidal. I might start, drinking alcohol. I might become an alcoholic. I might become addicted to drugs." Because when she left, I broke down. My ego structure was relying on her. My ego structure was relying on something else. So a difference between a weak ego and a strong ego is that a strong ego does not need anything from outside, right? It does not need anything from outside. No, bro. Kabir Singh has a poor ego. Yes. So, yeah, I was going to say that. Kabir Singh has a very bad ego. So a strong ego does not need anything from outside. I don't need to tell you I am good or bad. I value myself. I value my own opinion of myself. I understand that I might not be the most famous dating coach or self-help coach in the entire world, but I am doing what I can to help other people. I am doing what I can to help other people. So if I see other people who are much more successful than me, I'm not going to feel bad about it. I'm going to be like, oh, that's amazing, man. One day I'm also going to be there. One day I'm also going to reach there. This is healthy ego. I don't need you to define me. I define myself. I give myself value. If you ask me, dude, what do you think on a scale of 1 to 10, how do you feel? I'm always going to say, dude, I feel 10 on 10. Even if I'm sad, depressed, lonely, I'm going to be like, I feel 10 on 10. I feel 10 on 10. I feel like I'm in control. I am always in control of my life. So I don't need you to define me. I don't need you to tell me whether my game is good or not. I don't need you to tell me whether I look good or not. You can have your own opinion. You can tell me your opinion. I don't have any problem, but I don't give a fuck. I don't care. Bro, have you heard something as penis size ego? Bro, penis size ego is again like a small ego. It is a quote like a small ego, but I have not heard it much. I think I've heard it a couple of times. Harmeet, just give me one moment. Okay. Yes. So I don't need you to define me because I define myself. I give myself my own rules. I have my own rules that are made by me. I have my own value systems that are made by me. I have my own reality, my own worldview that is made by me. I have my own self-image that is made by me, right? But if you have a weak ego, you're always going to be looking for approval of other people. If other people are giving you compliments, you're going to be happy. If other people are not giving you compliments, you're going to be sad and miserable. If other people are talking to you, you're going to be happy. If other people are not talking to you, you're not going to be happy. If you have a weak ego, you will always look for external circumstances or external results to validate yourself. This is what a person with weak ego will think. I am not attractive because I am not getting any girls. Girls don't like me since I'm not attractive. Girls don't like me since there is something wrong with me, right? I am a low value person because other people don't like me. I am a low value person because I don't have that much money. So a person with weak ego will need outside gratification, will need outside reassurance. You will need somebody else to tell you how good or bad you are. And you're always going to be torn apart. You're always going to be fluctuating from this to that, from this to that. Yeah, Harmeet.
So the whole thing is like healthy ego will be where you will always try to improve yourself, and you don't need others to, you know, validate you or justify you. Like, you don't justify others and you don't need others' validation or anything.
Yes.
Exactly. Okay. Got
you. Don't need other people's approval. Okay. You don't need other people to like you, right? You like yourself, and that is good enough. So in a very simple way, understanding healthy ego is something like this. Bro, right now I am what I am. I am awesome the way I am, but I want to become even more better. I want to become even more awesome. I want to reach even a higher level of existence, even a higher level of self-mastery. So this is a healthy ego. Like, I am good. I am healthy. I am okay the way I am. I accept myself the way I am, but I also want to become the best version of myself. So in simple, this is what a healthy ego is. This is how you can get a healthy ego. Let's talk about the reality checks. Why are you still here? Why did you join this webinar? We have 22 people. Why are you still here? Why did you join this webinar? Why are you unhappy or unsatisfied with your current situation or your current dating life, maybe current sex life, maybe current love life? What is the unhappiness? Are the goals that you have, are your own goals, or are you trying to be like somebody else? Are your goals of your own choice, or are they influenced by somebody else? A lot of people develop goals based on what other people do. For example, when RSD Julian came and he started making videos, everybody started doing what RSD Julian was doing, and everybody started acting like RSD Julian. The existence of RSD Julian influenced their own goal. The goal that they have is not themselves. For example, let's say What can be a good example? What can be a good example? What can be a good example? Yeah. For example, let's say, have you guys heard about the band Linkin Park? So Linkin Park is a very famous band. And what happened that the that the lead singer of the band committed suicide. He killed himself. Right? He killed himself. And why did this happen? I'm going to talk about an extreme case so that you understand the picture. Okay. Why does it happen? So what happens is once you start to become a little bit famous, once you start to become a little bit popular, a little bit successful, that takes hold of you. You are possessed by the feeling of success. You are possessed by that feeling. You are possessed by the feeling. And instead of going after what you want, you start going after this fake image. You start going after this appreciation that other people are giving you. So the goals are dictated by other people onto you, right? Other people tell you what your goals should be. There's the same thing. If you ask a person who is doing a 9-to-5 job, why are you doing this 9-to-5 job? He will give you vague answers like, I think, you know, this is a good enough job and I was happy with this job. Or if you ask somebody like, for example, if you ask other people, why do you want to get laid? Or why do you want to become good with dating? A lot of people say things like, when I was a kid, when I was growing up, I had no girlfriends and I was single. And I had a girlfriend that cheated on me. Somebody left me. I was broken. So this is the reason I want to learn game. So their goals are a reflection of what other people have done to them. Their goals are not their own goals. Their goals are a reflection of what other people have done to them. So you have to ask yourself this question. If you are unsatisfied or unhappy with your own life right now, where is that unhappiness coming from? And the next question you have to ask yourself is, are the goals that you have chosen are your own goals, or are you trying to be like somebody else? Maybe you're trying to impress your family. Maybe you're trying to impress other women. Maybe you want to impress your friends by learning game. A lot of people learn game because of this reason, that they want to go out and they want to approach in front of their friends and they want to take the number of the girl so that they can feel good about themselves, so that they can get the, you know, applause from their friend. Like, wow, kya bhai, bhai, tune kya kamal kar diya. Bhai, what the fuck have you done? Bhai, you are so amazing. You just approached a girl. So a lot of people learn game because they want to be cool in front of their friends. These are not their goals. These are not even their goals, right? Some people want to get good with women so that they can show their ex-girlfriend, ki bancho dekh kya miss kar rahi hai tu. This is what you're fucking missing in life. You betrayed me. You cheated on me. I'm going to show you what the fuck you're missing. So after that point, their entire life becomes a process of just proving themselves to their ex-girlfriend. They're not even living for themselves at this point. They're living just to prove themselves to the ex-girlfriend, or maybe to their friends, or maybe to their family, or maybe to somebody else. So ask yourself, are your goals your own goals, or are you trying to be like somebody else? You're trying to prove yourself to somebody else. You're trying to impress a group of people or maybe another individual. Are these goals influenced by someone else, or are these goals your goals? Another point, untargeted discontent. Have you guys heard about this untargeted discontent? Ooh. Okay. No. So what is untargeted discontent? Untargeted discontent is a feeling, and everybody has this feeling, right? Try to tell me whether you have this feeling or not. A feeling that something is not right. but you can't really put your finger on a particular thing or a particular area that is giving you unhappiness. There's a feeling that, bro, something is not right in my life. I don't know what it is. I don't know what the missing piece is. This, the same thing happens in game. It doesn't matter how good you become at game. You're always going to be unsatisfied. You're always going to be like, bro, there is something that I'm missing. There is something that I'm lacking. There is something that is making me unhappy. So a feeling that something is not right, but you can't really put your finger on a particular area or a particular thing. So you have to ask yourself this question. Do you even know what you're looking for? Or are you just window shopping from one coach to another, hoping that you will find something shiny, which will give you a new sense of hope or inspiration? So bhai, sach batao, how many people have done this? You have jumped from one book to another book, to another book, to another book, one coach to another coach, one coach to another coach, to find the secret. Ki finally, I will get something that will change my life. Finally, I'll get something that will give me a sense of hope. How many of you have done that? Honestly, batana. It happened during the complete lockdown with me, being unhappy for no reason. So how many of you have jumped from one thing to another thing to another thing, one book to another book? Yeah, Shafin, bata. Yeah, guys, do you have any questions? So first of all, Shafin had asked him this question. Shafin, koi question pucha tha bro, bata. If not Shafin, then Raj, yeah, bro, you tell me. Yeah, Raj, tell me, you have a question. Okay, Raj, I cannot hear your voice. Maybe your voice is not coming to us. Or maybe tune galti se apna question raise kar diya hoga. So,
am I audible now, Rahul?
Yeah, Raj, you are audible now.
Yeah. So that, like you were telling, from going from one coach to one coaching, while reading one book after another book. So it's actually for finding something, no? To finding the right for,
yes,
fit, right that. Match.
Yes, I understand that. But do you know what you're finding? Do you know what you're looking for?
Yes.
What it is? What is it?
Currently, it's like currently the game, man. Currently, it's only the game.
Okay. So, bro, yeah. you are a part of one-on-one coaching, na? So, iske baare mein to hum baat karenge acche se. We will get to the the bottom of this. Okay.
Yeah.
So this happens with a lot of people. Like chat mein bhi bahut saare logon ne bola hai ki, yeah, this happened with me. I have been doing this for 2 years. You know, it's still happening with me. So a lot of people have said this. And to be honest, I have also been there. I have also gone through this, that jumping from one thing to another thing and one thing to another thing. And I don't even know what the fuck is wrong with me. I don't even know what am I looking for. I don't even know what kind of answer I'm looking for, what kind of problem I want to solve. So this happens, like people jump from one shiny object to different, because every new shiny object gives them a new hope, gives them a new inspiration. Sorry. Yeah, Meshak, you raised your hand, bro. You wanted to say something?
Yeah, bro. Is it like the search for that, like that one magic pill that will improve you?
Yes.
Like, a technique. In search, yes. Like, okay, I'll be searching for a technique like such as frame control. Like,
yes.
Okay, if I learn it, it will change my game. Like,
yeah. Is
it
so like you will that? See this. You will see this in the next point. You will see this in the next point. So the next point here is, don't you wish somebody will just come and tell you what life is all about? Somebody will come at your door like, bro, what the fuck you're doing? Come here. I am going to show you how to game. I am going to tell you what life is about and what your role or your job is in all of it. What is the right way to go forward so that you can close your eyes and follow your instructions? Don't you just fucking wish that one day a coach comes on YouTube and he has all the answers? He just tells you, bro, ye kar, bro, ye kar, bro, ye kar, bro, do this, bro, do that. I have done this, right? I was from a small city, then I became a millionaire. Follow me. Don't you just wish somebody will come and somebody will just tell you like fucking what to do? Identity crisis happening with me. Sorry, but I told you guys this is going to be a hard session. This is going to be a tough one. So guys, all of you have who have raised your hands, give me 1 second. Let me complete this slide and then I'll come back to you all. Keep your hands raised. So everybody just wishes, right? Everybody just wishes. Like somebody will just slap me and tell me, "Bhai, kya bakchodi kar raha life mein? Do this, do that, do that." And you can close your eyes and you can blindly trust that person and you can walk on his path. You can just walk on his path. This is in, you know, in psychology or in deep depth psychology, this is what we call as being a man without religion or being a man without God. Right? Because in ancient times, our ancestors understood it very well that if a person has no God to follow, has no king to bow down to, has no purpose to fulfill, he will become destructive. He will either destroy himself or he will either destroy something else. So he has to be taught something. Somebody has to come and tell you, "Bro, do this, do that, do that. You don't need to use your brain. I have given you a fucking structure. Just follow that. You will get the result. I'm telling you, I have given you a fucking structure. Just follow that." And we are like, "Yeah, finally, somebody told me something. Finally, I will not have to go through the uncertainty. Finally, I can follow somebody else blindly because I don't believe in myself that I can get where I want to go by myself. So I need somebody else to tell what the world is to me. I need somebody else to dictate, ki bhai, this is what the world is about. Bhai, this is what life is about. Bhai, this is what women want. Bhai, this is what attraction is. Bhai, this is what selection is." Everybody has their own version of truth and everybody is very, very self-righteous that my version of truth is better than everybody else's version of truth. All Christians think that Christianity is better. All Muslims think that Islam is better. All Hindu thinks that Hinduism is better. All Indians think that India is better. All Americans think that America is better. All Russians think that Russia is better. All Chinese people think that China is better, but they have their own version of truth. What is the actual fucking truth? This is the difference between a social truth and an objective truth, or what you can say as a subjective truth or an objective truth. The same thing happens with knowledge. The same thing happens with coaching. The same thing happens with leaders also. People just want somebody to just come and hold their hand like a dad holds the hand of the son and just guide them. Like, "Beta, mere ko follow kar, main tujhe batata hun kaise hota hai. Take my hand and follow me. I'll tell you how life works." Yeah, Meshak, now you can ask your question.
That was my question, bro. Like, you explained it.
Okay. So yeah. Anshul, chalo, I'm lowering your hand. Anshul, you had a question. Tell me what your question was.
The thing that you were telling ki apan we have an ego or like hum log alag alag window shopping kar rahe hain, bro. Like, yeah, this really hated me. So bro, you want to say ki bro ki apan jo hai like hum log ko like this religion to nahi manne ka hai kyunki hum log destructive ban jayenge, to kya hum log ko apne khud ka religion banana hai? We have to create ya khud healthy, ya the way we look at life, kya hum log ko khud ki life banani hai?
Correct.
There's
a very amazing dialogue. I'll just repeat it and I'll just let you continue with the question. Just 1 second. The dialogue is, our war is a spiritual war. Our journey is a journey of personal development. Our journey is an internal journey, right? Our war is a spiritual war. So we have to make our own religion. We have to stand for a cause. We have to stand for a purpose. This is the reason every book that you will study about men, the first chapter is going to be, every man has to find his purpose. You better find your fucking purpose as soon as you can. So that purpose becomes your God. That purpose becomes your religion. For me, my purpose is personal development. My purpose is, building something that can help men of India. Building something that is not just about dating. It's not just about fucking going and getting the result. Like, there was a guy who was asking me a question. He, "Bro, there is a girl in the office that I like. Can you tell me what lines can I use so that she can sleep with me? I'm like, bro, are you fucking chutia? What the fuck you're asking me? Do you think that we're going to give you, you know what, if you have so much of problem, and this is what I told him. I'm like, bro, if you have so much of problems getting laid, buy a stripper, buy a hooker, go to a red light area, go and have sex. If you want that magic trick, the magic trick is money. If you just want sex, pay for sex, you get it. Yeah, Anshul, please continue. I'm sorry, I'm just ranting. So please continue.
Yeah, bro. Like, or like, there's a spiritual quote. Maine padha tha, like, we in our body, we have all the temple, river, sacred river, and everything that we need. So, like every religious people also say that the journey is enough, and like you are also saying. So, bro, in what way hum log apne life ko dekhein ki we become satisfied from the inside.
इन वॉट वे हम लाइफ को देखें सबसे पहले बात ब्रो लाइफ को देखने का है कि यू वॉन्ट टू बी अ पर्सन हु इज एमिंग टुवर्ड्स पर्सनल ग्रेटनेस हु इज एमिंग टुवर्ड्स सेल्फ डेवलपमेंट सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन यू वॉन्ट टू बी अ पर्सन ओके हु इज एमिंग टुवर्ड्स इंडिविजुअलिटी हु इज एमिंग टुवर्ड्स ओरिजिनैलिटी बट यू ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू बी अ पर्सन हु हैज सम ग्राउंडेडनेस हु इज ग्राउंडेड इन अ कम्युनिटी हु इज ग्राउंडेड in some kind of a bigger cause, bigger than himself, right? So like, for example, Elon Musk. Elon Musk is a person who wants to become one of the best business people, who wants to become rich, who wants to create his own empire. But at the same time, he's doing everything not for himself. He same time, he understands that everything he's doing is in the service of other people, is in the service for somebody else. So like metaphorical example, a warrior, every warrior needs two things. The first thing is being very, very, very good at his craft, being very, very good at his own weaponry, at his own fighting skills. Every warrior needs this, but because without skill, a warrior is useless. But a warrior also needs a king to fight for. If a warrior is fighting for himself, he becomes a bully. A warrior needs a king to fight for. A warrior needs a cause to fight for. A warrior needs something to surrender to give to yield to, right? Samajh mein aaya Anshul main kya bol raha hu?
Yeah, bro, yeah.
Yes. So this is, you have to have a balance between surrendering to a greater cause and becoming, you know, the best version of yourself. You need to have a balance for that. You can't just try to become the best version of yourself for your own sake. Because you will always feel empty. You will always feel hollow. And you can't just blindly surrender yourself to life and to other people. Because then you will become a brick in the wall. Then you will become a cog in the wheel. Then you will become the part of the rat race. You need to strive for personal greatness. Also, you need to strive for a bigger cause, which is greater than yourself, which is beyond your own needs. Do you understand this?
Yeah, bro, amazing, bro. Like, it's really hated me. Yeah.
Cool, bro. So moving ahead. So this slide is clear to everybody. We are going to move ahead. There are some chats. I'll quickly read the chats. Identity crisis happening with me and I'm thinking, who am I? Yes. Yup. Aren't mentors supposed to be those people who lead us to success? Yes, exactly. Mentors are supposed to be those people who lead you to success. But when mentorship becomes marketing, then mentorship is ruined. Next, goals. What is required to become a person like that? What is required to be an integrated male? To become individuated, what is required to become that alpha, to become that king in your own life, to become that leader, to become that unconflicted man who has charisma, to become that influential person? What is required? The first thing which is required is inner work. This is the first thing which is required. Inner work. Knowing yourself, knowing your value systems, and integrating all parts of your personality inside out. So knowing yourself means who are you? You have to shed and you have to get away from the social conditioning layer. You have to get away from the layer of what other people are imposing on you. You have to get away from this layer and you have to reach a deeper layer, which is unfiltered, which is not socially conditioned layer of you, right? So inner work, peeling off the layers of conditioning, peeling off the layers of years and years of fucking conditioning. The second thing is understanding how to express yourself or being known by another. Game, and this is where game and communication skills comes. This is the part of game and communication skills or social skills. The third part is active listening, which is having the ability to know other person. The fourth part is understanding the step-by-step process of taking the interaction forward, how to smoothly take any interaction from starting point to where you want the interaction to go. So again, previously we have been talking about alpha males. Previously we have been talking about the effect alpha males have. What are the qualities of the alpha male? What makes an alpha male? We have talked about those things. Now we are narrowing our conversation to game and attraction and dating. Now we are going narrow, okay? We started from a broad perspective. We started from king, warrior, religion, you know, blah, 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 psychology. We started from all of that. Now we are becoming a little bit narrow. So now we are going to talk about focus on narrow things. First thing which is required by all of us is inner work. Second thing is ability to express yourself properly, which is game and communication skills. Third thing is understanding how to know another human being or learning about active listening. The fourth thing is understanding the step-by-step process of taking the interaction forward. So most people just focus on point two and point four. Most people just focus on game and just focus on understanding step-by-step. They don't have any inner work. And again, let me again break an ice. I don't believe in inner game. I used to believe in inner game before, but right now I think that inner game is just another word for self-esteem or self-confidence. So let's not talk about inner game, because inner game is about your mindset. Inner game is about who you are as a person, your own self-value. How much do you evaluate yourself? That is inner game. So inner game comes under inner work. But most people focus on point two and point four. They completely ignore first point and the third point. They completely ignore the first point and the third point. But this, all these four things are required in order to reach where you want to reach, in order to become that unconflicted person, in order to become that integrated being. So the process to become integrated. So guys, right now I'm going to take a 2 minute of break. We have 21 people. We are going to take 2 minutes of break and then come back, okay? So we still have some ground to cover. So when we come back, we are going to talk about the process of becoming integrated. We are going to talk about the process of becoming that alpha, becoming that natural that we talk about. And after that, we are going to talk about Q&As. After that, we are going to do some questions and answers. Cool?
Yeah, man, that's great.
Yes, yes, yes.
Awesome.
तब तक कोई बातें करो I'll sing a song.
Because we are all shy, bro. That's why.
I'll sing a song, okay?
till our teacher comes.
Bro, it is getting recorded.
यार तो कहाँ पे जाने वाला है? SBI के पास थोड़ी जाने वाला है. Teacher has left the chat room. क्या यार बकचोदी चल रही है साला. कब खत्म होने वाला कोरोना क्या मतलब? ये वीक में किस किस किसने किया है अप्रोच? Has anybody started the game? Hello. Hello, 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 hello. Hello. ना ब्रो, अरे बात कर यार. चालू चालू हो गया फिर से.
What's up guys?
Welcome back. What's up?
Teacher has left the classroom. It's time to in our game for backup fuel there. Very good, except that there is less density on the street. Game to a mushkil hai bhai log. Game is difficult to start. Okay, so let's talk about the process of becoming integrated. This is going to be the most important part of today's webinar. This is going to be a place where we are going to spend some time. So the first thing is start of the journey. How does a journey starts in pickup? How does a person starts his journey in pickup or in person development or in game or in dating? First thing is a lot of people start the journey after a breakup or realizing that a lot of life has been wasted without any fun experiences. Or maybe they go through loneliness and they're like, bro, I've had enough. I've had enough of this bullshit. Now I want to make something out of my life. Some people also go through depression or maybe anxiety, or maybe they just have an ambition that I want to become better with women. I want to become better in, you know, with social life, with my dating life, with my sex life. This is where most people start their journey. So can you guys tell me about what happened to you when you start this journey? Why did you start this journey of becoming better with women or becoming successful with dating?
Bro, when I started, मेरे गले से आवाज ही नहीं निकलती थी.
अच्छा, so you are basically like going through like social anxiety kind of stuff, right?
No, no. When I started 2 years back, so I had no approach anxiety and stuff. But जैसे ही उधर मैं पहुंचता था, मतलब as soon as I opened the set, ऐसा लगता था मेरे गले में कुछ फंस गया है.
हाँ, that is called anxiety. इसी को बोलते हैं anxiety.
अरे मुंह से आवाज ही नहीं निकलती थी. इट वाज रियली वेरी डिफिकल्ट, बट आई स्टार्टेड टू यू नो प्रैक्टिस मच एंड आई एम रियली गुड राइट नाउ.
गुड. आई वांट टू इंप्रूव माय सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड फियर ऑफ टॉकिंग टू पीपल. ओके कूल. सो दिस इज वेयर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल स्टार्ट. अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल स्टार्ट द जर्नी एट अ पॉइंट ऑफ ब्रेकअप. लाइक फक मैन, ब्रेकअप हो गया, नाउ आई नीड टू यू नो बिकम बेटर, नाउ आई नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट दिस डजंट हैपन अगेन, नाउ आई नीड टू have more abundance so that if one girl leaves me, I don't care. or there is no effect in my life. Or some people start their journey because they realize that, fuck man, I'm 30 and I have never had a girlfriend. I have never had a fun. I have never hooked up with somebody. Now that I have some money, now I have that I have some job, I have a career, I want to have some fun. So this is also where a lot of people start, like realizing that they are missing out on sex and on fun and on dating. They have a fear of missing out. A lot of other people start from loneliness. Like they are sick and tired of becoming lonely, becoming depressed, being a socially anxious or shy person. And they're like, fuck man, I want to be better with this. I want to learn this. This is so bad. I hate myself. Why am I so shy? Why am I so insecure? Why am I so anxious? Why am I so depressed all the time? Why am I so lonely? And a lot of people start the journey at this. This is a point of being introverted or being depressed. A lot of people who come into game, fear of missing out. The realization that I am not good with women. I feel that I have no understanding about women. Okay. I want to improve myself. Got it. So a lot of people are having the same kind of starting points. This is a point where a person is introverted, or we can say a person is depressed. Depressed is not as in depression. We are not talking about psychological depression. We are talking about depression as in just living life in sadness. Just, you know, living life like a zombie, like not being seen. Nobody remembers you. Nobody calls you. You are invisible. You are living, but nobody gives a shit about you. That there is nobody who is calling you. You like sometimes you feel that as if you just disappear from this world right now, nobody will even ask you. Nobody will even be sad, like where this guy went. A lot of people are starting from this point. And this adversity or this pain becomes a fuel for the journey, right? This becomes the start of their own journey. This becomes the journey of personal development, of becoming more integrated, becoming better version of yourself. This pain, this suffering, right? This ground level, this like, you know, hitting the bottom, hitting the rock bottom. This adversity, this gives you courage. This gives you fuel. This gives you anger. You're like, fuck man, now I want to do something. Now I want to do something with my life. Now I want to do something different. I promise myself that I am not going to be the same person I was before. And you promise, this gives you the fuel. This gives you a path. This gives you an ambition, a goal, that now I want to fuck a lot of chicks. Now I want to have a lot of girlfriends. Now I don't want to be relying upon one girl. Fuck this, fuck that. All girls are assholes. You just have to fuck everybody else. So this is where the journey starts. This is where the journey starts of becoming better with women or becoming an alpha or becoming integrated. The second stage is the start of the war. So this is where your battle begins. When you're fucking sick and tired, and when you have decided, when you make that decision that now I'm going to go to a coach, or now I want to improve my life, or now I want to do something differently, right? Now I want to stand back up on my feet. This is the start of the war. This is the start of the battle. So at this point, you start reading or looking for a way out of your gutter. You start looking for a way out of this hell that you are stuck in. That what the fuck is happening with my life? I have no friends. I have no girlfriends. Nobody calls me. Nobody cares about me. Nobody gives me a hug. Nobody is there to have sex with me, right? Nobody comes on my birthday. Nobody fucking calls me on my birthday and be like, hey, bro, what's up? How have you been? My old friends have forgotten about me. I don't have any new friends. What the fuck? So at the start of the war, you start to realize that you need to go into the fucking battle. And this is the place where a lot of people start taking action. Just watch some YouTube videos, how to approach a girl. And they start going out and taking some action. This is exactly what I did, right? So I did not have a breakup. I did not have a bad breakup. It's just that I had bad experiences with women. Right? Women made fun of me. Women were like very, very mean to me. And I could not understand why is this happening. And one day I just have had enough. And one day I'm like, bro, fuck this. अब नहीं हो सकता मेरे से, I cannot take this anymore. Like these girls are being such an asshole. They are being such bitches, right? They are being so bitchy with me. What the fuck is wrong with them? Sometimes I felt like I would just slap somebody in the fucking face. I would just punch somebody in the throat. Sometimes I would get so mad, right? I was in this gutter, and then I started looking a way out. Then I started looking for somebody who can help me. Then I searched for simple pickup videos, and I saw that simple pickup videos with those guys would go out and pick up any girls. Just give me a moment. People are taking action online. Even more challenging is taking action during lockdown. Yes. Right. Awesome. So this is the start of the war. You start reading or watching videos, or you start, you know, torrenting, like you download some courses by torrent or by some privacy, any kind of stuff, right? And you start to go out and take action on your own. You try to become your own father. You try to become your own mentor. You start becoming your own mentor in the second phase. बिना बात करे लड़की कैसे पटाए शाफिन थोड़ा शांत थोड़ा आराम से इतने ज्यादा हाई एम्बिशंस नहीं लेने हमें. Awesome. You start taking action. You start asking for help. You start doing something to change your current situation. You take a leap of faith into the unknown. This is where you become extrovert. This is where you have hope, like something good will happen. Bhai, kuch to hoega. Agar main action lunga, itne sare log bol rahe hain, bhai, action le. Go out and do something. Every coach is saying the same thing. So if I do that, something has to happen. I will get some kind of results. So we become an extrovert. We come into the phase of hope. Then we start talking to other people. Then we start interacting with other people. Then we start going out regularly. A lot of people just give up. A lot of people are like, bro, mere se nahi hoga. Somebody is unmuted. Guys, can you all mute yourselves? There is some, kisi ki awaaz to aa rahi hai. Ranjit, muted. Awesome. So let's continue. So at this point, at the start of the war, a lot of people give up and they just go back. They just go back to their sad, lonely, depressed cave. They just go back to trying to get back that ex, right? And then they search how to get your ex back. Then they find about no contact. So you stop contacting her and stuff like that. So all these techniques, because they are scared of the war, and a lot of people withdraw. A lot of people go back. A lot of people are like, bro, mere se nahi hoga ye. I can't do this. It's better that I wait for my parents to find a good girl for me. So I'm just going to focus on my studies, on my career, so that one day, mere baap maa mere liye ek achhi bandi dhoond lenge. One day, I will get some decent girl, right? So a lot of people go back at the second stage. They are scared of entering into the war. But some people do enter the war. Right, some people like me, it may be you, it may be other people, right? They enter the war without knowing with any certainty that they're going to get results or not. I started going out, I started taking a lot of action. I saw a lot of people doing the same things. They have no idea what they're doing, but they are taking a lot of action. After taking a lot of action, some people also go for boot camps. Some people also buy courses. Some people also, you know, take help from other coaches, right? And they start getting some better results. They start becoming better and better and better and better. So they reach to the third phase, which is finding the treasure or your power. As you learn more and as you keep on taking action, you become more confident. You start getting the results and you finally get a control over your life. You finally get some results, right? And this is the part where people become players. This is the part where people, you know, start acting like fuckboys. This is the part where people start acting like narcissistic assholes. Because after taking action, after taking help of a coach, they get this superpower. They get the treasure. They get the magic treasure. They get the magic pill. Like, now I can go out and I can get the result. So once they get this, once they understand this, what happens is they have an ego inflation. Now they're like, I'm going to go out and fuck all the girls. Now they become greedy. Right now they enter into a zone of false grandiosity. They start thinking that they are better than other guys because they know game. They start thinking that they are better than everybody else because they know game. They develop an inflated sense of self. They are like, bro, I'm the best. Manchud Mahiu. I am the person that everybody should look up to. You start asserting yourself on other person that I am right, you are wrong. What my way of living is right, your way of living is wrong. Right? So when we find the treasure, and this happens with everybody, I think that this happens with 99% of people. When you first start getting results, your ego will be inflated. You'll be like, wow, man, amazing. Now I can do anything that I want. When I first started getting result, I became sex addicted. If I was not going out every day, I felt that I was wasting my life because I needed to go out and maintain that false ego, maintain that inflated sense of self, maintain that inflated sense of ego. I became greedy. I started having this grandiose idea like, wow, you know, I'm going to have a harem. I'm going to have like 5 chicks that are having sex with me at the same time. I'm going to be lying on my bed just like Dan Bilzerian is lying, and there are going to be 3 chicks sucking my dick. Right? This is what I started thinking. This is what I started feeling. My ego became so inflated. Yes, bro. This is a hero's journey in Pick Up Content. I haven't reached that stage. Damn, bro. Awesome. So Parth is like, what's your score, bro? So I hate this question, but I think like around 51, 52. Awesome. So finding the treasure. This is the second last phase. When you find that treasure, when you finally become good enough to get results, then you start thinking that now you can do anything. Now you start treating women like objects. Now you start treating people like objects. What happens? One day, this bubble is broken. One day, this bubble bursts. And what do you feel? You feel existential crisis. You again go back to depression because your ego was on the sky, right? It was same as there was a guy who got wings and he felt that he can touch the sun. So he started flying higher and higher and higher so that one day he's going to touch the sun. What happened? The higher he felt, the higher he flew, his wings start melting. And then he fell down on the ground and died because his ambition was not in his check. He developed a false sense of ego that now he can touch the sun. Now he can become a god himself. Now he can become the king without sacrificing anything. Without giving anything, without surrendering himself, now he can become the king. So what happened? The ego got boom. The ego was destroyed. The identity was destroyed. Bro, kisi ka mic khula hua hai? Aditya Singh, muted. Yes. So then boom happens. A boom happens. And then your ego is destroyed. Then you learn humility. So this is the final stage of an integrated man. This is where you become integrated. You go through a catharsis. You go through a metaphysical death. You go through a death of yourself. You go through an ego death. This is a popular term, right? Ego death or ego dissolution. You go through an ego dissolution. You go through this ego death. And then you are reborn again as an integrated male, as an alpha, as a pure leader, as a purely integrated male. You start becoming king. You start reaching towards your own identity, your own power, right? So every time you get the superpower, we want to hold it back. We want to hold that superpower, right? We want to have that superpower all for ourselves. But that is what kills people. You have to give the superpower. The superpower, that power came to you for an instant. You played a role. You played a role for a moment that you needed that superpower. But now that you have attained that superpower, you need to let go of that power. You need to share that power. So can you guys relate to all this that I'm talking about?
Yes.
Yes. So we have, I went in very, very depth of the process. So just to repeat this, just give me a moment. Yes, just to repeat this, what happens is we start as an introvert, right? We start as a newbie. We start as a shy guy. We start as somebody who is going through loneliness, breakup, depression, right? Lack of self-confidence. We start from this place. Then we take action and then we reach to a place where we are getting some kind of result. We are going out and taking action, right? We are practicing this. We are practicing that. We are learning about new stuff. We are, you know, approaching girls like this. We are approaching girls like that. We start becoming that. After we do this, after we practice enough, we become a player. Then we feel that I can fuck anybody else. I can do anything. I can, you know, like whatever the fuck I want to do, I can do it. Then we become a player because we have a false sense or an inflated sense of ego. Then what happens? A girl comes and you fall in love again. And then she breaks your heart again. And then you again feel the same thing, which is your catharsis, which is your metaphysical death or metaphorical death. You feel this death. Just like the phoenix, you die and then you are reborn again and the cycle continues. This is the cycle. This is the upward spiral of game. Have you guys ever heard about spiral? Upward spiral of game.
Yes.
So this is the upward spiral of game. You start from here and you keep going like this. You keep going like this. And this cycle will continue once, twice, thrice, four times, as long as it takes for you to become an integrated male, as long as it takes for your ego to become strong, for your ego to become an individual. The fuck happened? Yes. So we go through these four phases. Start of the journey, we start our journey somehow, then we start the war, we start taking action, we start taking coaching, we start learning, we start getting some results, then we find the treasure, we find what works for us. But then what happens, we become greedy and we want to have all of that for ourselves. So what happens, this power destroys us, right? This greed, this need to come, you know, this, like, you know, greed for ambition, this greed for more and more and more and more and more destroys people. And then what happens is your ego is destroyed. Then what happens is your bubble is burst and you are left out alone. And then you pick up yourself and then you learn how to control your ego and you learn how to be humble. Instead of taking, you learn how to give, you learn how to share. You understand the meaning of collaborative frame. You understand the meaning of intentions. You understand the meaning of vulnerability. After you go through this death, you understand the meaning. These things cannot be understood intellectually. These things cannot be understood by your brain. These things have to be felt. These things have to be experienced. This is what we call as an experiential growth, not a logical growth, not a fucking intellectual masturbation. Okay. This process is a process of growth in which you are going to grow through experience, in which you are going to grow through life. So you become an integrated man. You must control your ego and make it humble. You have to ground your ego. You have to ground your ego. Instead of taking, you must learn to give. You go through a metaphorical death or a metaphysical death, and you are reborn again as an alpha. And every time you go through the cycle, every time you go through the cycle, your character, your personality, your being, your sense of self, your alpha-ness will become stronger and stronger and stronger. And every time you'll become more like a king. It will come a point where you will have completely integrated yourself, and then you can safely tell yourself that you are an alpha. You are indeed a king. So I'm going to share my stories. What are people talking about? Can lead to point one and point two as long as it takes for me to become an employee. Awesome, 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 awesome. No, bro, I'm not a pickup god. I haven't reached that stage yet, dang. So you become aware of your morality. Can you tell what is vulnerability in true sense? Can you tell what is vulnerability? So bro, are these kind of questions afterwards. So this is a process. Anybody has any doubts? Because I want to share a couple of stories with myself.
Bro, मतलब इसी से related doubt या फिर मतलब मेरा थोड़ा general doubt था।
हाँ bro, बता ना।
Bro, मेरा ये है कि जैसे मैं मतलब कुछ time से game कर रहा हूँ और मेरे को जैसे second stage तुम कह रहे थे मेरे को okay okay result मिल रहा है, but मैं ना मतलब मेरा ये हो रहा है कि ना मैं काफी self sabotage कर रहा हूँ क्योंकि मेरा ऐसे है कि जैसे अप्रोच किया तो लाइक काफी कॉन्फिडेंट कॉन्फिडेंट अल्फा लीडर टाइप का दिखाते हैं, बट लाइक पुल में वगैरह में ना मेरे को नहीं एक्सपीरियंस, तो मतलब मेरे को थोड़ा वैसे है यार कि
क्यों
ज्यादा
पुल वगैरह में क्यों,
मतलब मेरे को ऐसे में ना एक्सपेरिमेंट रिसेंटली ये मतलब ध्यान दे रहा हूँ कि बहुत फालतू का एक्सक्यूज बना रहा हूँ, और मतलब कि मतलब मेरा ये है कि बातें वगैरह में नॉर्मली में काफी मतलब मतलब थोड़ा अच्छा हो गया, मैं कॉन्फिडेंट टाइप ओके उतना अच्छा नहीं, बट मेरे को उतना एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है फुल वगैरह का, तो मतलब ऑकवर्ड हो जाएंगी वो पूरी डेट पे गए उससे आगे मतलब पूरा अजीब सा हो जाएगा।
ऑकवर्ड होने दे, एक बार सुन के तो देख कितना मजा आता है कि व्हाट द फक इज रॉन्ग विद यू, यू आर ट्राइंग टू स्लीप विद मी एंड यू आर यू गो लाइक यस आई एम ट्राइंग टू स्लीप विद यू लेट्स गो एंड देन यू देन शी इज गोना बी लाइक ब्रो यू आर सच अ वियर्डो एंड देन यू विल बी लाइक ओके फाइन, एक बार करके तो देखिए, लेट इट हैपन, लेट इट हैपन, उसके बाद तुझे पता चलेगा बस इतना ही था एंड देन द फियर विल गो अवे एंड देन यू विल बी एबल टू, नाउ अगेन बिफोर फाइंडिंग द ट्रेजर वन मस्ट फाइट द ड्रैगन एंड ऑफ्टन टाइम्स द ड्रैगन इज योर इनर साइड योर सेल्फ योर इनर शैडो योर डार्क साइड योर वीकनेसेस राइट, सो बिफोर फाइंडिंग द ट्रेजर बिफोर वी रीच टू द थर्ड स्टेज we must fight the dragon, we must defeat the dragon. Somebody has raised their hand. Yes, Sai, what's up?
Bro, actually I've seen this pattern again and again in my life, bro. Like I'll be going through something, I'll be developing myself in such a way that I'll be doing everything, suddenly people around me will start pulling me down again, I'll go down. Again, I'll be going down, like approaching, I'll be doing everything. Again, it will go in such a level that I'll be getting something. Then I'll feel like, you know, like shit. Again, I'll stop it. So is this a regular pattern happens to everybody?
Yeah,
like, I feel it's like generally happening to me.
With every human being. Bro. This is called the personal myth. This is called the personal myth. So this happens. This is called the hero's journey. This is called the process of individuation. So what I'm sharing with you guys is... I'm sharing with you guys a mixture of analytical psychology, mythology, and philosophy from an angle of pickup, from an angle of dating. So I have simplified this a lot because if I started giving everything, then it would become a book. So that I am telling everybody, I have been telling everybody that the way you become better at game is the same way you become better at everything else in life. If you understand how to master one thing, you will understand how to master everything else because the process is same. The process of mastering anything is same. You just have to understand the process. And I'm just trying to give you the process here. So Raj, yeah, tell me.
My question was regarding, as you said that you want some answer and you keep finding out. Getting one book after another, getting one coach after another, and after a certain period, one finds that there is still no results.
Yeah.
Whether it is about the money, whether it is about the game, whether it is about anything else. So, what, according to you, what is actually the problem? Is the actual problem with the guy, or the actual problem with the coaching, or other something third?
No, bro. Actual problem is not with the guy. Agile problem is not with the coaching. It's about you. It's about, we fail to understand that. So let me give a kind of a story to explain what I mean, right? So there was a point of my life where I had went through my first breakup. This is like 2015 or 2016, right? I have went through my breakup. I was dating this girl and we dated for like 8 months. And all of a sudden she was like, Rahul, I am serious for somebody else. I don't have the feelings of love towards you. So I think this is it. I'm going to move on. And I cried a lot. I broke down. And my self-confidence, my self-esteem went to the ground. But after that, after a couple of months, I went to the club. I liked this girl. I took her number, right? I took her number. But this time I was not trying to game. This time I was not trying to game because I was trying to maintain my ego, right? I was trying to maintain my ego. Like, I am a pickup artist. I must not be needy. I must not be needy. And I tried to game her. But it would never work. It would never work. It would never work. Bhai, kabhi kaam hi nahi karega ye. I was trying to flirt with her. I was trying to do push-pull with her. I was trying to pull her. I was trying to take her number. I had met this girl 4 times in a club. And I really liked her. Right? Ye bandi Shitij wagera ke group mein thi. Ye bandi Shitij Shashank ki friend thi. And I really, really wanted to fuck her. I really liked her. Right? I thought that she was very cute. So what did I do? Is one day I just got fed up. One day I'm like, hey, listen, I have been trying to talk to you since last 2 months. Every time I ask you for a number, you give me an excuse. What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? Am I doing something bad to you? Am I saying something bad to you? What the fuck do you want from me? And then she gave me her number that day. And then the next day, I'm calling her to come home. I'm calling her to come home. She is not coming. I again got pissed off and I'm like, hey, listen, what the fuck is wrong with you? How can you do this to me? You know, we have been having an amazing time. What is stopping you? Like, why are you doing this to me? Why do you want, like, why are you trying to break me down again? I have told you that I have just went through a breakup. If you don't like me, just tell me that you don't like me. Why are you keeping me in between? What is fucking wrong with you? And then that girl was like, hey, sorry, I was busy somewhere else. You know, I had to meet some relatives. I had to meet some friends. There is a shadi at my place. So I have been very, very busy and I've been very tired. Then I told her, no, you know what? Shut up. I don't want to meet you. Let's not meet ever again. This is it. I cannot waste my time with you guys. I cannot waste my time on girls like you. Then she's like, hey, calm down. I didn't mean to disrespect you. I didn't know that you were going to feel this way. And I told her that I am so angry right now. I'm feeling so frustrated. I'm feeling like I would never want to talk to any girl again. Then she's like, hey, you know what? It's late right now, but tell me if we can meet or not. And I was like, yeah, but I know that you are just bluffing with me. You're not going to come. You're not going to come and meet me. Then she's like, send me your address. I'll come there. So after this entire fight, I sent her the address and she came. I sent her the address and she came. When she came, we sat on the rooftop for 3 hours and we talked. I broke down in front of her. I cried in front of her, right? Because I just wanted somebody to listen. I just wanted someone to sit there and listen to my fucking story. Right? I was sick and tired of, you know, pretending to be a gamer, pretending to be a pickup artist. I'm like, what the fuck, man? I'm in such a bad mental space right now. And I'm going and I'm trying to be happy for everybody, but I am not happy myself. And after that, the moment I let my ego get destroyed, that moment, I felt a sense of peace. Like there was a lot of weight that was removed from my shoulder. I felt light. I felt okay-ish again. In one night, my entire view of women, my entire view of game changed. I'm like, dude, women can also be busy. Women are also people. They also have their own desires, their own intentions, their own goals. Who the fuck am I to tell them they should be sleeping with me? Who the fuck am I to tell them what to do or not to do? So the moment my ego got humbled again, my false sense of greatness went away. And I realized that, yeah, shit, man, jo itna kar liya, lekin phir bhi, I'm just a human being. I have to wake up in the morning. I have to take a shit. I have to piss. I feel sad. I'm getting old. Because I was getting results, and I was in an amazing relationship. So I felt as if I am not human anymore. I felt as if I have reached the greatness. Mujhe aisa laga ki I have transcended the world. But this one experience, this brought me down to earth, and I realized that, bro, I'm the only human. Everybody is just a human being. But this comes later at a phase. So Raj, when we work, again, what I'm telling you right now, I can only tell you this, I can only explain you this when we are working one-on-one or when we are working, you know, on some process so that you will realize, right? So this is the reason. But did you relate to my story?
Yeah. I'm much relating with your story.
तो भाई मेरे को ना एक्चुअली क्या करना पड़ा कि आई हैड टू लेट गो ऑफ द नीड टू कंट्रोल एवरीथिंग ऑल द टाइम एंड आई अंडरस्टूड दैट यार कभी कभी बीइंग नीडी इज ओके बट आई हैड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हेन बीइंग नीडी इज गुड कभी कभी इट्स ओके टू बी वल्नरेबल बट नॉट ऑल द टाइम कभी कभी इट्स ओके टू बी वल्नरेबल कभी कभी इट्स ओके टू बी अ ह्यूमन बीइंग टू फील सैड टू फील दैट यू आर न�ट पावरफुल इनफ To feel that you're not like a perfect human being or perfect creature. So when we realized that, then I stopped faking or pretending in front of girls I was talking to. Then I stopped faking. I was myself with girls, right? So the phrase that we use, be yourself,
right?
It came a full circle, right? And I reached a point where agar main kisi bandi se baat kar raha hu and the interaction is going very well, I would be like, hey, you know what, like, I am enjoying talking to you. It is completely your choice whether you want to come with me or not. If you don't want to come with me, that's completely fine. And sometimes girls are like, no, just let it be. This is an interaction. I'm like, yeah, fine, cool. Uske baad bandiya message nahi karenge, uske baad I would not even take her number. Sometimes girls are like, yeah, I want to come home with you. Let's go. Yeah, let's exchange numbers. Let's meet somewhere. So this is the point where I reached. Like, I did not need to force game in order to get her. I'm like, bro, fuck it. I already have some results. I already am getting good enough results. And I don't want to, you know, I don't want to do something wrong so that I get broken again. So I integrated myself in this process. So bro, you fucked her that night? Yeah, bro, I fucked her that night. Let's go with Shitij brother.
Dude, is it prior to your Vipassana experience?
Yeah, it is prior to my Vipassana experience. Bro, Shashank is Shitij brother. Awesome. So, next slide. Now we have talked about the process of integrating. Right, we have talked about the journey, we have talked about the full circle. You start from a place, then you go next phase, then you go next phase, then you go next phase, then you reach there. You start from zero, you take action, you become a player, you get destroyed, and then you become whole, then you become integrated. This is the process. In order to get something, you have to give something, right? Life is like a dealer, life is like a crossroad demon. Right. Have you guys heard about crossroad demons? Have you guys heard about selling your soul?
Illuminati,
right? So what does Illuminati says? That, bro, I can give you anything that you want, but what you have to give me is half of your life. Right. This is exactly what life is like. Life is like, bro, I will give you everything that you want, but you have to be willing to die for it. You have to be willing to die for it. So life is also like a dealer. Life is also like a, you know, negotiator. Like, he is negotiating with you. And that is very interesting. This is such an interesting thing to understand and to go through. Can't tell you guys. Yeah, lambe baal wala. Bro, introverts, extroverts, kaise bane? Bro, abhi to humne baat kari iske baare mein. They are integrated. We fucked her that night. Okay. So abhi iske baare mein baat kari, bro, humne. So we are going to talk about the layers of integration. And this is now even more narrower. We have been talking about terms. We have been talking about broader terms. Dheere dheere, we are narrowing it down. Gradually, we are going to the point. Okay. The first layer of becoming very, very, very good at dating and becoming an alpha male is the verbal layer. And this is the beginner layer, right? When you start game, everybody has to start at a verbal layer, right? Or technical layer. How to approach, what to say, what kind of approaches are there, how to handle a shit test. Like if you ask me right now how to handle a shit test, I will, like if you ask me, Rahul, how do you handle a shit test? I'm going to be like, bro, mujhe shit test nahi milte. I don't think that I am getting shit tests, because like at one point it will happen with you also. At one point you will reach at a place where you'll be completely blind to the shit test, where you'll be so blind to the shit test that, like, for example, if the girl is trying to make fun of you, you have no problem. Like, yeah, fun, man. You are making fun of me. That's a good thing. I have no problem. I know myself. It doesn't matter. Whatever, whether you say good things about me or whether you say bad things about me, I don't care. So it doesn't affect me anymore. Chaps. Jesus says the same thing. Oh, calm down. Meshach. बंदा तो एकदम अचानक से जीसस को घुसा दिया इंटरेक्शन में.
I can't help myself, yeah.
Okay, fine. So the first layer is verbal layer or a technical layer. Understanding the technique or the process, practicing and integrating the technical and the verbal side of the communication, experimenting with different things and different techniques. So this is the first layer of your mastery. The second layer is a mental layer. In the mental layer, you are going to develop a sense of self-confidence, self-trust, self-belief, self-esteem. You will identify your insecurities, your flaws, your weaknesses, and you will integrate it. So you're going to identify your shadow and you are going to integrate it. Then you're going to understand your emotional architecture and mindsets, and you will start integrating them one by one. Then you will update your self-image, your belief systems, your mental blocks, your blind spots, your self-sabotaging behavior, your fear, etc. So the second layer of mastery is the mental layer. The third layer of the mastery is the spiritual layer. Mastering the spiritual or the energetic side of things. In spiritual layer, if I have to define spiritual layer by one line, it is going to be like, you will reach to the spiritual layer where you will feel that you are one with everybody else. You will not see a difference between yourself and the other person. Like, this happens with a lot of people who are very, very good in game. They think that everybody is their friend. They think that everybody is just like themselves. So they reach at a spiritual layer. But in order to reach at a spiritual layer, you have to go through verbal layer, technical layer, and your mental layer. So have you guys ever thought about, we are all one? Have you guys ever heard about this? The principle of divine unity. This is the first principle in spirituality, the principle of divine unity. Have you guys heard about this?
Yeah.
Yes. So this is the final layer. When you stop the judgment of beautiful, ugly, of good, bad, of men, women, right? When you stop the judgment, and when you start understanding that everybody is going through a same life, everybody is going through the same journey, everybody has their own problems, everybody has their own flaws, and everybody, no matter how rich, how good looking, how poor, how depressed, everybody is looking for answers. Everybody is feeling what we have talked about, the untargeted discontent. Everybody feels that there is something missing in the life. And if they get that something, they're going to become a happier person. They're going to achieve their goals. Everybody is looking for that secret. This is the fucking reason law of attraction became so famous, because everybody thought that this is the secret. This is the secret. This is what the world needs. This is what will solve all my problems. But it did not, because there is no secret. Have you guys watched Kung Fu Panda?
Dekhiye.
Usme, do you guys remember that when he was making noodles, Kung Fu Panda asks his dad, "Dad, how do you make so good noodles? What is the secret?" And the dad says, there is no secret. There is no secret. So when you reach to this layer, then game will become so easy for you. Like game will become something like, you know, like driving a car or riding a bike. Game will become almost automatic. Like you will want to approach somebody else because you'll be like, there's a, that person will be happy to know me. I'll be happy to know them. This is a new experience I'm giving myself and I'm also giving to that person. You'll be happy to meet people because in your mind or in your reality, you're like, I'm providing an amazing time with two other people. I'm having fun with everybody else. Yeah, Aditya.
Bro, ये जो होता है ये मतलब practice के बाद ही आएगा.
हाँ, मतलब when you practice, when you become good with girls, then तू एक बहुत अच्छी बंदी से मिलेगा. You will fall in love. Then वो बंदी तेरे पे cheat कर देगी. Then तू थोड़ा रोएगा. Then again तू ground zero से start करेगा. And then this will happen again and again and again. After 2, 3, 4 times of this happening, you will reach at a place where you will see every woman, every girl as a human being, not as a girl. You will start to understand your own value. You will start to understand that, like, this is what a friend of mine was telling me. He's, bro, sometimes if I have sex with a girl and if she is not my kind of girl, I feel very guilty. I feel that she is using me because at this point, what is happening is that he understands his own value and he understands that just having sex with somebody else, just giving my energy, my emotions to anybody else is a waste of my time, is a waste of my life. So that person has, like, because he had an amazing friend circle and he had dated like really, really amazing girls that I've seen. So he was at a point where he could feel the, you know, oneness with everybody else. He could feel that he's not different from other people, right? He's not different from other people. He's not better or worse than other people, right? Good looking people are not better or worse than him. Rich people are not better or worse than him. Good looking girls are not out or in his league. He reached to that point. And I also reached to that point. I also felt the same thing. And then only I decided to get into dating coaching. Then only I decided to get, this happened. I have exact moment when this happened. So in 2018, this happened. In 2018, I have been getting good results. I have been getting amazing results at that time. I was dating this chick, told you guys about, the girl I met in summer house, the girl, you know, who refused to come, who refused to meet me. And I was like, why are you not meeting me? Please come and meet me. What is wrong with you? I'm feeling so bad. So I cried in front of her. And then she finally came and meet me. After that, I dated a girl from Chicago. She was a white girl. I dated her. And then after that, I dated like a black chick. She was from New York. After that, I dated one other girl. She was from Gurgaon. She was from India. She was from Gurgaon. After that, I understood that I have no problem whether these girls are staying in my life or not. Like, it doesn't matter how much I like the girl. If she's like, oh, Rahul, I need to go to a new city. This cannot go on. You know, this is not going to work. I'm like, awesome. Go. If that makes you happy, go do that. They're confused. Like, what? You're just going to let me go like that? You're not going to say anything like, why are you going? Are you not going to fight with me? What is wrong with you? I'm like, you want to go, so go. I can go out and I can meet anybody else easily. I love you, but it's your life. You have to, you know, do what makes you happy. So after that couple of incidents, I realized, I looked back at my life and I realized, what the fuck is happening? I'm dating my dream girls right now. I'm dating the girls that I have dreamt about. Like, dude, a guy from Bihar is dating a girl from Chicago, is dating a girl from New York, is dating a German girl, is dating a French girl. I'm like, what the fuck? And it's so easy for me to let them go. It's so easy for me, like, yeah, that's completely fine. If you don't want to have sex with me, that's completely fine. I don't mind. I don't have any needs from you. I don't need to have sex with you. I am feeling amazing the way I'm feeling. If you just want to sit and talk with me, I'm happy. If you just want to have sex with me, I'm happy too. If you just want to go out with me to shop, I have no problem, right? If you just want to become my friend, that's fine. I don't need anything from you. I am full the way I am. So this is the analogy of a son, that at that point I felt that I was overflowing with value. And it is my responsibility to share this value, to share this emotion with everybody else. This is the reason I was talking to people. I was not talking to people for myself. I was not approaching girls for myself. At that point I was approaching girls because I thought that they would be happy to meet a person like me. I thought that it would be a blessing for them to meet a person like me. Then it became a little bit chaotic. And then I thought that I can become a coach now. I can coach other people. That this is the point where I was like, oh, this is the turnaround. I think that I have reached somewhere. I have known something. But it took me 2 years to understand what I actually went through. It took me 2 years. So now what I'm telling you guys, it took me 2 years to understand. Partho, secret is nothing. Bro, we have been talking about all the layers now. Partho, we have been talking about verbal layer, technical layer. We have been talking about mental layer. We have been talking about spiritual layer. So I told you guys at the start of the webinar that this is going to be an overall structure, the overall process of becoming that alpha male. Once you know this process, you can identify where you are right now, where you are stuck, or you can take help. You can decide to take help. You can decide to be like, bro, you can help me. Please help me. And if you don't know this stuff, and if you keep on taking action, you will keep on falling here and there. You will keep on, you know, like you will keep on like finding mistakes, and you will keep on finding things that you will be like, bro, what the fuck am I doing wrong? I'm doing everything right, but I'm not getting the result. What is wrong with me? You will get frustrated. I have seen guys who have been going out for 8 years and who have gotten like one or two lays. Bro, I know dating coaches who were coaching when they had zero lays, zero. When they had zero, how about zero? They had zero lays. They have never had sex with anybody. They just read the book Game and then they started coaching. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? I thought that, you know, I was meeting a guy and I was like, dude, I'm meeting another dating coach. It's so exciting. I was so excited. When I went and when I actually started talking to him, I was like, bro, this guy has no game. And I was completely fine. I'm like, I don't mind if your game is, I am not judging you based on how good your game is. I have no mind. If you are a good friend to me, if you are a good person to me, I'm going to be a good person to you. I don't care if you're a virgin or if you are Dan Bilzerian. I don't give a fuck about that. So I'm roaming around with this guy. And what happened? He was talking to two girls, right? I was just standing next to him and I was just listening to those girls. And I was just, you know, joking here and there in between. So I knew that it was his set and he wanted to take the girl's number. So I thought that I should not interfere. Maine socha ki yaar bhai ko na aaj bhai ko lene de. Aaj bhai ko le jaane de bandi, bhai bhi yaad rakhega, bhai bhi khush ho jayega. I was like, let's do it for the brother, for my brother. But what happened? He took his number and he went home and the girl texted him, hey, who was that guy who was with you? And he's like, what, why, what happened? Do you know him? She's like, no, he was very cool. Can you give me his number? He was like, which guy are you talking about? So the girl said, there was a guy now who was wearing a black jacket. So it was winters and I was in Delhi. I was wearing a black jacket. So he got very confused. He got very angry at me. Like, bro, tune meri bandi chhin liya. I'm like, bro, I did not even do anything. I just stood. I was standing there. And he had to give me her number because she was asking for my number. And usne bola ki, bro, pehle to mera man nahi kar raha tha tujhe number dene ka us bandi ka, lekin I thought I should give you a number because it would be wrong. I'm like, yeah, bro, fine. So I took her number and then in 3 days, after 3 days, we met and we had sex. And I told him, and he was like, bro, photo bhej mere ko, photo bhej. I'm like, nahi bro, photo to nahi bhejunga, attention. Don't worry, I'm not going to send you a photo. If you don't believe me, that's fine. I have no problem. You can go out and shout to the world that Rahul is a liar. I don't have any problem with that. India. What is this Indian? Indian alien. Bhai, mauj karate. I feel like I got into state listening to all of this. So, Meshak, crazy bro. So guys, this is the layers of integration. Verbal layer, mental layer, spiritual layer. At this layer, you might reach after 1 year or after 2 years or after 3 years. I'm just giving you where to go. I'm just showing you the end game. I'm just showing you the end result. I'm just showing you what is the end result of all this and how amazing it is going to be when you are at the end result. Everything will become light. Everything will become easy. Everything will become part of the process. Everything will become fun. You will become one with the process. You will become completely one with the process. This is layers of integration. What are the tools that you need in order to master this? You need online dating, you need social media, you need text game, you need verbal game, you need day game, and you need night game. And finally, you need a social circle and a good lifestyle. So this is the entire process. This is what the entire process is about. Awesome. Now, what I want to propose you, like right now we have gone through the entire structure. Right now we have read, understood. We have gone through the entire process, the meta process of game. And now we are going to talk about how to accelerate this, because the truth is, in order to reach to this point, I had to sacrifice my college. I had to sacrifice 3-4 jobs. I had to sacrifice all my savings. I had to sacrifice my entire, you know, early 20s. From my 20 to 26, I had to sacrifice everything else just to understand this. Because for me, understanding this was the most important part of life. Just to understand this, I sacrificed that entire thing. And now that I have some experience of coaching other people, some experience of guiding other people to this journey so that they can become that integrated male. They can become that alpha. They can become the king that they want to become in dating, in game, in social life, in their social circle, wherever. You can integrate your personality. You can integrate your dark side, your bright side. You can integrate your shadow. You can integrate every part of yourself. You can integrate your feminine side and your masculine side. You can integrate the technical side of the game, the verbal side of the game. And you can have everything in one plate. So that it doesn't matter. Like, this is going to be something that will solve your problems permanently. So there is an amazing line in a book I read somewhere. I don't remember the name of the book. So the line says, there is already too much truth in the world. And overproduction, which apparently cannot be consumed. This line was said by Otto Rank. Otto Rank was an analytical psychologist. He worked with Sigmund Freud. He worked with Carl Jung. He worked with a lot of like Alfred Adler. He worked with a lot of different psychologists. And he has written books on creativity. He has written books on the nature of human beings. So this is something that related with me. Like, this is something that, you know, hit me very hard. Yes, it is right. There is so much truth in the world and overproduction, which apparently cannot be consumed. So it doesn't matter how many, you know, books you consume. It doesn't matter how many things you consume. You will have a knowledge. You will have a knowledge, but you will not have an understanding. Knowledge is different from understanding. Knowledge comes from reading something. Understanding comes from experiencing something. Understanding comes from experiencing that process. So if you want to experience the process, if you want to go through the experiential journey, right? If you want to see all the layers of your personal development that you have to go through anyways, then you can hit me up and we can go on a one-on-one mentorship. We can reach your personal transformation. We can reach your final version, or the version that I like to call the king. And this is something that I would be working on for the next of 2021 or maybe 2022. This is something that I will be working on. Okay, this is going to be the main matter of what I am going to be working on, right? I wanted to go deeper today, and I wanted to give you a broader understanding, right? Because if you want to go somewhere, if you want to go to a new city, you have to understand the map. If you don't understand the map, you'll just be lost. After understanding the map, you also have to understand the territory, right? You also have to understand the territory of how to go from one place to another place. So let's see. You're awesome, bro. Please don't stop having this meeting after you become very famous and popular after some years. No, bro, I won't. Why are we starting with online game? Bro, there is no structure. There was no order. It was just like all these three things, right? Online game, social media, text game, a day game, night game, all these things are tool. They're not ranked. This is not a priority. This is not on a level of priority. I'm going from easiest to hardest. So online dating and social media being easy, where you don't require a lot of effort, and social life, social circle and lifestyle is hardest. So I'm just going from easiest to hardest, not the priority thing, just the easiest to hardest.
And bro.
Yeah, bro.
ये जो अभी तुम बोल रहे थे इसमें ये जो होता है कि while approaching having a positive mindset कि मतलब reject क्यों करेगी friendly होगी वो लड़की या जो भी है so like does this also come in that या फिर ये मतलब normally conscious रहना चाहिए हमें कि ये भी practice से आएगा
bro एक बार फिर से question पूछें
कि मतलब जैसे हम approach करते हैं बहुत बार ये होता है कि before even approaching हम जा ही रहे हैं कि अरे यार ये तो बिची लग रही है reject कर देगी तो ये माइंडसेट चेंज प्रैक्टिस के साथ ही होगा या फिर नॉर्मली कॉन्शियस रहना चाहिए इसको
नो ब्रो ये माइंडसेट मतलब प्रैक्टिस के साथ ही होगा तू समझ ना ब्रो आदित्य राइट आदित्य बात कर रहा है ना
हां भाई
ब्रो तू समझ ना जब तू एक बंदी को अप्रोच करने जाता है तो कितनी सारी चीजें दिमाग में चल रही होती है ब्रो आई कांटेक्ट मेंटेन करना है स्माइल मेंटेन करनी है ब्रेकिंग रिपोर्ट टोनालिटी मेंटेन करनी है बॉडी लैंग्वेज अच्छा होना चाहिए बंदी के बहुत क्लोज नहीं जाना है बहुत दूर नहीं रहना है लीन इन नहीं करना है लीन आउट नहीं करना है राइट वी हैव टू ऑफर वैल्यू राइट इतनी सारी चीजें दिमाग में रखेगा तू सो तू तुझे लगता है तू कुछ एक्शन ले पाएगा नहीं ले पाएगा तो ये सारी चीजें तुझे कॉन्शियसली नहीं सोचनी है जब तू बाहर जा रहा है तो राइट जब तू बाहर जा रहा है तो तेरे दिमाग में एक ही चीज रहनी चाहिए बैमचोद मजे करेंगे आज समझ रहे तेरे दिमाग में एक ही चीज रहनी चाहिए कि ब्रो काम खत्म क्लब चलो गान फाड़ के डांस करो ये रहना चाहिए तेरे दिमाग में दैट्स इट तेरे दिमाग में ये रहना चाहिए ओ भाई आज तो बाहर जाऊंगा आज मैं ये टेक्निक यूज करूंगा आज वो टेक्निक यूज करूंगा एंड ऑल्सो एक और चीज बता दूं आदित्य एंड एवरीबडी एल्स हु इज हियर लाइक देर आर लाइक वेन आई गो आउट इफ आई टीच समबडी देन आई टेल देम दैट देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ लाइक देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ थिंग्स दैट यू विल बी डूइंग ऑन अ वीकली बेसिस फर्स्ट वन इज यू विल गो आउट जस्ट टू हैव फन Second one is you will go out to practice a particular skill or a particular technique. Third one is you will go out for results. You will go out for results. You will have an agenda when you go out. When you are going out to practice a particular thing, like for example, if you have to practice leading, right? Let's say if you have to practice baby stepping or leading, then you're just going to go and you're just going to be like agenda free. You will not have any outcome in mind. You're just going to be practicing. Some days you will go out just to have fun. Some days you will go out in order to get results, in order to get a pull, in order to get as many numbers as you can or as many insta rates as you can. So you cannot, again, you have to understand why you're going out and how to progress. Again, bahut sari cheez hai, bro. I'm telling you, my job in all of this is to make it simple. Right now, the world does not require more complexity. दुनिया ऑलरेडी बहुत कॉम्प्लेक्स बन चुकी है राइट उधर ट्रांसजेंडर मूवमेंट आ रहा है उधर somebody, you know, has like बकचोदी हो रही है दुनिया में इधर लाइक पीपल आर फाइटिंग दैट मेन एंड वुमेन आर सिमिलर देर आर नो डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेन एंड वुमेन like you have, do you have any idea how complex the world is becoming? Like this type of game, you have to ask for consent, right? What do you like? Hame dar lagta, right? If I go out, approach somebody, somebody will file a case against us. In such cases, hame dar. World is very complex. So my job in all of this is to make it simple for you, right? Is to make it simple for you, not to make it even more complex. So this is the reason main hamesha na ek bigger picture ke bare mein baat karta hu tum logo se. I talk about the big picture of what social skills are like, of what game is like. So this big picture is important. Once you understand this big picture, things will become simpler. Once you understand your journey, things will become simpler. As Chitish say, first 100 approaches are just warm-ups. Bro, could you now tell us about vulnerability? Okay. Chalo, so let's go back to our chat. So guys, how are you feeling? How is everybody feeling?
Amazing, bro. It was amazing.
Meshak. So Partho, Kiran, Sai, Abhilash, Ayush, Ranjit, Mr. Sanket, Spetsnaz, Aditya, Shantanu, Prabha, Kiran, Anish, Himanshu. Are you guys awake? Are you guys alive?
Ah, bhai, conscious? Bahut awake.
Kisi ko khana wana chahiye kuch? Are you guys tired?
Dude, this is kind of a personal question. Have you tried martial arts?
Awesome. Yep, wide awake, so everybody is chatting. Yeah, main chats pe dhyan nahi deta yaar, mujhe lagta hai tum log kuch bologe yahan pe aake. You will say something in the mic so that I can hear your voices. Yes, bro. Himanshu. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So bhai, ab let's talk about vulnerability. Ye kisa question hai? Abhilash ka question hai, right? Abhilash.
Yes.
Bro, vulnerability is not pretending or not faking a character, not playing a character in front of other people. Vulnerability is like showing what you really feel. For example, if you are in an argument with somebody and that somebody says something mean to you, right? But they are your friend. But they are your friend, right? So in this case, you have to be vulnerable. In this case, you'll have to be, bro, you have to say something like, bro, that made me feel really bad. Bro, don't say that. That made me feel really bad. This is vulnerability. You're being vulnerable, right? You're showing your emotions. You are okay with showing emotions. Vulnerability matlab, bro, kya bolte hain? Hindi mein kya samjhao vulnerability? Hindi mein iska kya word hoga Hindi mein? Vulnerability is more like apne aap ko chupana nahi, jo hu andar se main dikha dunga. So whoever I am from the inside, I am showing it as it is. I am not lying to you, or I am not making up a truth. I am not making something up. I am not filtering myself. This is called vulnerability.
Like being transparent bhi bol sakte.
Being transparent, yes. But being transparent does not always mean that you are nice. If you are truly vulnerable, right. Zaruri nahi ki you are always going to be nice or you are always going to be emotional. You can be vulnerable with anger too. You can be vulnerable with aggression too. You can be vulnerable with arrogance too. You can be vulnerable with your, you know, transparent with your boundaries. Right?
Like jo bhi hum moment mein feel kar rahe usko truly express karna, wo vulnerable matlab usko
saying what you want to say.
Okay.
Saying what you truly, truly want to say.
Okay.
Yes. So guys, I hope you like the entire webinar. And if you want to connect to me one-on-one, and if you want to talk with the journey, if you want to talk about this journey, then you can reach out to me on WhatsApp or on Telegram. You can, you know, send me a, like you can send me a DM and then we can talk about this. And we can also talk about one-on-one mentorship. If you are interested in taking the one-on-one mentorship so that the journey can happen quickly, right? this journey is about making mistakes soon and learning soon. Make mistakes often, make mistakes frequently, and learn from those mistakes. So we can go through the entire journey. So if you're interested in knowing a little bit more about how this journey can help you of where you actually want to go, then you can let me know. Because the thing is, bro, another important fact of pickup community or dating community is 95% of people never get results. A lot of people come in this dating industry, in this pickup industry, they're going to be like, yeah, I'm going to learn this. I'm going to fuck so many bitches. Yeah, bro, amazing. But what happens at the end is they just leave. 95% of the people never get the results that they want to get. Because they procrastinate. They are like, "Arey bro, I have a lot of time. Dekha jayega na future mein. Jab zarurat padegi tab lunga. I will take a coaching when I'll need one." So they wait. But what happens? The moment you wait, 3 years passed, 5 years passed, 10 years passed. And right now, a lot of people who are like 32, 33, he's like, "Bro, I have wasted my entire life. I should have done this earlier. Why didn't I do this? Pehle maine kyun nahi socha ye? Bro, can I still get good with results? Can I still get good with women? Can I still get successful at dating?" I'm like, "Bro, agar tu jaag jata 10 saal pehle, it would be much easier for me. It would be much easier for you. But since tu thoda der se jaaga hai, it's okay. It's just going to take a little bit more time, but we can make it happen." So you guys, a lot of guys, when I came to Bangalore, a lot of guys were like, "Bro, I'm saving money right now to take boot camps." All of a sudden, COVID happens. All of a sudden, lockdown happens. And 2 years completely fucking gone out of the life. In the last 2 years, nobody gamed. Last 2 years is like fucking destroyed. Everything is destroyed. I'm like, "You wanted to wait, so good thing, wait." So you have to understand this, guys. It may sound a little bit harsh, but 95% of the people who get into game, they will not get the results. They will leave game miserable, unhappy the way they came. Some people will leave game even in a worse state than they came in. There are only a handful of people who are actually going to achieve their goals, who are actually going to become truly attractive with women, who are actually going to develop this alpha personality. And I want to tell you, I want to give you a guarantee that this alpha personality is in you. This part of you is inside you. It's just sleeping. It is there. It is there. You can get the result. You can reach this place. And let me also tell you that the journey is going to be very difficult. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. I'm not going to be like, "Arey bro, bahut asaan hoga." It is not going to happen. Bro, the journey is going to be very, very difficult, very, very painful. But you can reach that result that you want. But you have to take action. You have to do some drastic change. If you want a good result, if you want to change your life drastically, you cannot just hope that someday things will be better. Things are never going to be better. You have to take drastic measures if you want to have drastic change in your life. You have to take big leaps of faith. You have to take some big decisions, some big actions if you want your life to change. There is no magic pill. There is no magic pill. There is no secret. We have talked about this. There is no secret. It completely depends upon you, whether you decide to do it, whether you don't decide to do it. It completely depends upon you. And this is something that I have found, especially in India, right, that people are just copy-pasting somebody else's content. People are just copy-pasting RSD content, Todd's content. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Don't you guys have anything original to tell? This is the reason me and my friend Abhishek, we started coaching. This is one of the big reasons. It's because, bro, these people are telling you exactly what is on YouTube. You can take this advice free on YouTube. But these people are charging you for this advice. This is a surface layer advice. What the fuck, man? You are telling somebody, have breaking rapport tonality and maintain eye contact. This advice you can get on YouTube. You can get 100 times better advice for free on YouTube. Okay? You can get 100 times better advice. So I'm like, why the fuck everybody else is not understanding this. Why the fuck people are not looking at this? Then I realized that fine, it's okay. I have been through a very, very difficult journey of my life in order to become good and in order to reach where I am right now. And this is the reason I think that this journey can be completed in a shorter period. This journey can be completed in 6 months or 1 year, or maybe even shorter. This journey can be completed in a shorter period. So if you want to go through this journey at a super fast speed, with a help, with a guiding hand, then you can let me know. You can DM me. We can start the coaching. We can talk about one-on-one coaching. And also, I was going to take some people. So only two seats are left. Only two slots are left for this one-on-one mentorship, for this one-on-one guidance, for this one-on-one complete help, complete support, right? So there are only two seats left. So you can text me, you can DM me, you can reach out to me, you can call me, you can let me know if you're interested in this or not. Because again, in future, everything is just going to be more fucked, right? Life never gets easier. Life only gets more difficult. This is the same as a bootcamp at home program. No, bro, this is not the same as bootcamp at home program. Now I think that it would be better to work with people one-on-one. So this is one-on-one coaching. This is one-on-one personalized coaching. This is not about bootcamp from home. Abhishek, coffee wali auntie ko Enfield. awesome. Pura video ka ek bar short mein summarize kar do, bro. Pura video ka cha. Bro, Abhishek, coffee wala VR porn hub lockdown. What is advice in lockdown? Cool. So, yeah. Guys, you want me to summarize the entire thing in a short way? Okay, so I'll try to summarize this in like 5-10 minutes. Okay, after that, we will end the webinar. Bro, how was your first pull? Bro, lambi story yaar. Baad mein baat karte hain iske bare mein. So just let me summarize the entire thing. Journey, self-transformation, and understanding the bigger picture. Ek second. What I wanted to become. So I wanted to become a magnetic personality. I wanted to become a person who exudes confidence. People see him and they want to be friends with him. Women see me and women like automatically are attracted to me. I wanted to have that kind of charisma. I wanted to be an alpha. I wanted to be super attractive, like a magnetic personality. But then I realized that if I have to become a magnetic personality, I have to give people what they want. And what did people want? What do people actually want? They want certainty and they want emotions. They want good emotions. And they want certainty. They want to follow someone. They want to make their life easier by following somebody. In order to become a person who other people follow, in order to become that person who has that certainty about himself and who gives those positive emotions, he has to integrate himself. He has to become an alpha. He has to integrate all parts of himself. He has to mature his ego. And he has to develop a healthy ego. Then we talked about reality check. There are a lot of people are unhappy or unsatisfied with the current life situation. So they don't know what their goals are. They don't know why they exactly want to learn this. They are not happy, but they don't even know why they're unhappy. So they're looking for somebody to handhold them. They're looking for somebody to guide them. Everybody is looking for somebody to guide them. Everybody is looking for somebody to just come and tell them the truth. This is the role of the alpha. This is the role of the leader. This is the role of the unconflicted person or the king, right? And this is what I wanted to become. But what it requires in order to become a king, inner work, self-expression, knowing another person and active listening and understanding the entire process. This is what will be required if you want to become a leader. Then we talked about how to become that character, how to become that personality, how to become that king. You will start the journey and you will have to go through the entire journey a couple of times. Then you will have a good sense of self. Then you will have self-trust, self-belief, and core confidence. So you start the journey, you start the war, you find the treasure, and then you go through catharsis, then you die, and then you become an integrated male. Layers of integration, dating, verbal, mental, spiritual layer. We have talked about this. Three things that are very, very important: verbal skills, mental skills, and spiritual layer. So we have to go across all three. Tools that will be required along the journey will be online dating, social media, text game, verbal game, day game, night game, social circle, and lifestyle. So this is not priority. I'm just putting them down from easiest to hardest. So online dating and social media being the easiest thing, social circle and lifestyle being the hardest thing. One-on-one mentorship. If you want me to guide you through this journey, if you want me to guide you through this journey of integrating your personality, of combining every aspect of yourself and understanding every aspect of yourself and being able to get the results that you want and see that transformation, then you can reach out to me. I'll be happy to help you. It is going to be amazing. It is going to be an amazing journey. So that was the entire webinar. Tejas abhi aa raha hai. Partho, what you're talking about is 5 inches enough. Chal kya raha chat. Does size matters for Indian girls? No. No, bro, it doesn't matter. Is the one-on-one coaching in field? Bro, right now it is going to be happening virtually. So it doesn't matter where you are. If you are in any part of the world, if you are in any part of India, you can take this one-on-one coaching. You can take this one-on-one mentorship. Bro, Abhishek, a coffee wali auntie ka, okay. Does size matter? No. How was your first pull, bro? Long story. 5 inches enough? Yes. Thank you so much, bro. Thank you so much, mister. Ayush, what is the fees? Bro, if you guys have any questions, DM me or call me directly. Because since this is personalized coaching, it will depend upon the kind of goals you have, where you are right now, and how long your process is going to take. So it will depend upon that, right? This is my general gyan nahi dene wala. I'm not just going to give you general gyan. I'm going to tell you exactly what you require right now to solve your current problem and move at the next stage. So Ayush, please DM me. Partho, we are talking about dick size. Partho, you should have better things to talk about, bro. Have some better things to talk about, Partho. Anyways, guys, so that was today's webinar. It was amazing. And it was good to have you all. This will be recorded and this will be put on YouTube so that you all can view it again. Thank you so much for coming here. Have a good day. Bye-bye.